my air. I'm sorry. I'll take the blame on that one.
By her own admission, she hasn't played very well, so today's 6-3 win over Japan was a confidence builder for Cathy Borst in Canada and keeps her among the leaders at 3 wins and a single loss. Switzerland has won 2 women's titles in 79 and 83. Cristina Lestander, though, from Zug, will need to make a big comeback. She's struggling. She right now is 1-3. Two former world champions, Helena Blacklarvis in Denmark, Andrea Schopp, Germany, they lead the table at 4-0. Canada in a trio at 3-1. Another group of 3 at 1-3, including Switzerland, 2 winless teams, Japan and the USA. And the US goes for their first win, Kari Erickson against Finland, while Japan, Mayumi Okatsu from Tokoro, tries to win against a 2-time world champion, Sweden. Boy, the weather couldn't be better. Here in Kamploops in the Ford Worlds on TSN.
It's something that happens some 250 times every day here at the Weyerhaeuser plant in Kamloops. Hi, everyone, and welcome back to TSN's continuing coverage of these Ford Worlds. Here at Weyerhaeuser, they use all these chips that come from some 22 mills around the Kamloops area. They use the chips to make pulp. Pulp makes paper, and they ship the pulp worldwide, primarily to Europe and to Asia. And in fact, some of the best paper pulp comes from this area because the trees grow so slowly. The fibers are tight, makes very strong paper. Coming up in the women's fifth draw, Canada, she goes against Switzerland and Cristina Lestander. And with their thoughts, that is one of 250 done. Let's join Lyndon Ray.
Truly pulp fiction, Victor. Do you think he'll be late for sure? He'll never get his hair back in place after wearing that hat.
And I thought maybe he'd get the dustbuster out with all the pulp out there. It is Switzerland tonight, and we're going to see a team that I know a little bit about. I know Cristina Lestander. She actually won a world championship under her maiden name Wurz with Erika Mueller in 1983. And I know it's tough to say this, but it is the skip, the experienced skip of this Swiss team that has to try and pull them together. She knows she's going to get a few misses out of her front end in her third. It is Cristina that has to play well. It's not easy also coming from Switzerland where the ice is so straight, and she's coming to a place where it's curling 4 feet, 5 feet. And finally, she's coming to a place in an arena where the draw weight changes a lot. And that is one thing that actually both skips have struggled a little bit about, but Cristina the most. Her numbers at draw are very low, 63%, a little better. It hit at 74%. Now, Cathy struggled slightly with draw weight, but her numbers are much better. So Cristina has to get a hold of the ice, has to get the read on the ice for her team, and she has to pull those draw numbers up. And Ray, Canada's playing a little bit better now.
Well, I really like what I see, Linda, because at the beginning of the week, they were a little indecisive about a lot of the things. I like what I see in Cathy. Now, they're a democratic team. In other words, they talk about a lot of things. They're very technical. They have all the splits. They're very involved in the game. Kate has a lot to do with the weight and deciding the weight and passing on that information. And Cathy was a little tentative about the calls, but I like what I see now the last couple of games. She really is more decisive. She's listening, but now she's deciding. She's adjusting to the situation. And that's a great sign because this game is a game of confidence. And if you ever lose it, we've seen people lose it. You saw Japan, for example, is struggling with the confidence. But Cathy and the whole team, they look like they're focused again. They're back on a little bit of a roll, and they'll be very, very difficult to beat tonight.
So we'll see if they can keep it on that roll, and we'll see if the body English, the slide from Heather Godbrson, comes into play tonight, Vic.
We know many of you have used our web address to keep up to date on our season of champions, and we hope you do here at the Ford Worlds as well. Player profile, score standings, all available to you at www.tsn.ca/curling. It's the women's fifth draw from the Ford World Curling Championships in beautiful Kamloops, BC.
Use the 98 Escort. It'll make you think twice. There's a sedan and a wagon. They're both very nice. Escort's quiet interior is first class. Great four-door styling is sure to last. Each have dual airbags if danger comes knocking, and premium speakers to keep you rocking. Plenty of room and handsome good looks. Escort's the choice, but there's just one hook. With two cars as great, you'll have to think twice. Both sedan and wagon are exactly the same price.
It was about the time that gold was discovered on Bonanza Creek that the Canadian Bank of Commerce set out on the epic trek to the Klondike to open the first official bank. There was plenty of gold, all right, but the men knew they could trust the bank because they were there on behalf of the government and could see a larger dream, a dream called Canada.
As in the past, CIBC continues to play a pioneering role by investing in Canada's vision of the future. Canadian Imperial Bank of Commerce, seeing beyond.
If you care, Simonize it. Get professional results at home with Simonize Gel Car Wash. Clean and enhance the shine of paint, leaving the protection of Teflon. Clean and protect your entire vehicle with Simonize Gel Protectant, bursting with nutrient-enriched beads. Each application revitalizes, nourishes, and adds the lasting protection of Teflon. The Simonize family of car care products are available at Canadian Tire.
You remember Jay. He still doesn't say very much, especially when he's enjoying his McCain Super Fries. And he doesn't seem to care that they've only got 5% fat because they still taste great. McCain Super Fries, deep fried flavor and crispness with only 5% fat. For the strong, silent type.
The Nikon Zoom 210 is a stylish, fully automatic, compact camera with a sharp power zoom lens. The Nikon Zoom 210 makes taking perfect pictures simple.
And he thinks he saved a bundle on the move. Yeah, right. Ugh. Next time I'm calling Allied.
Thank you, Canada, for making Allied the biggest and best in the country.
Jays take on the Twins, TSN, Tuesday and Wednesday.
The 1998 Ford World Curling Championships on TSN are brought to you by Ford Motor Company of Canada Limited, by Canadian Imperial Bank of Commerce, Seeing Beyond, by Labatt, Good Things Brewing, and by Simonize Car Care Products. If you care, Simonize it. Simonize is available exclusively at Canadian Tire. We're at the Riverside Coliseum here in Kamloops for this women's fifth draw. And our featured game is on sheet B, Switzerland and Canada. And like a good referee, the ice makers have been invisible, but their ice has been noticeable. It's been great. BJ Gagnon and Hans Wutrich.
You know, Victor, it's a little bit repetitious if you've been with us, but when you watch the practice, it's curling the same. It curls about 4 feet around the centers. When you go around the corners, about 5 feet, and we've been saying that all week. However, as the game progresses and the frost starts to creep in a little bit, you do get some change. One of the keys to this game will be the judgment of brushing, and it starts out in this area here, and you have to anticipate the curl, the big curl, get on the brushing and hold them, because the rocks will slow up as they get into this painted area. You have to be very careful.
The two skips, that's Cristina Lestander on the left and Cathy Borst on the right. Throwing the lead stones for Switzerland is Anik Lusser, and it's Kate Horn for Canada. The twin sisters, Madalena Brulou, is at second, Brenda Bomer for Canada. Her sister, Selena, is at third with Heather Godfredson for the Canadians and the two skips. Representing the Zug Curling Club in Switzerland, it is Cristina Lestander. And from the Otwell Curling Club in Edmonton, Canada's Cathy Borst. Switzerland has won the coin toss. They'll play the red stones, Canada yellow. And so Canada will throw first. Switzerland with the hammer here in this first end. And to get us going, the Canadian lead is Kate Horn.
You'll see the good numbers for all the Canadian players as they step into the hacks. And in every position, Canada has better shooting percentages than the Swiss team. And that's why I said it's important for Cristina Lestander, the Swiss skip, who has the experience, to try and keep this team focused tonight. And it's not easy for a skip. You're down the one end. The other three players are trying to prepare themselves at the other end. But I really do think Cristina could be the factor tonight.
And I'd like to just expand on my comments in the opening, Linda, a little bit. You know, it's we talk about confidence. And the last couple of games, especially, Cathy has listened and discussed, and then she's been very definite. There's been a couple times, for example, where there's been a little bit of question. Cathy, is that too much ice? No, this little cut here. And one of the things that's kind of interesting is that Cathy Borst won the Scott Term of Hearts, and she won it fair and square with great curling. And she's been around. She lost the final of the Scott Term of Hearts. So we know in this country how capable she is. But she comes to this event without a reputation. In other words, the teams that are here have been, many of the teams here have been to many world championships, so the intimidation factor is gone. So if they see in any way a crack, in a little bit of a confidence crack, so it's important that Cathy be very decisive and the team ooze that confidence. And you have to do that with shot making, obviously. But you can't for one moment let those opposition, I don't care what game you're playing, know for 1 minute that you may be, you know, not sure of what you're doing. In the last couple of games, Cathy's put the broom down, she's reading the ice better, and that will pay her dividends.
But Linda, it's Canada, and usually, to play devil's advocate, usually when Canada steps on the ice, the opposition is worried.
There is a little bit of that because they know how difficult our national championships are, how many games it takes for Brenda and the Team Canada group to get to this level. But as Ray says, they have not been seen on the international stage except for Heather Gobrison in the World Juniors, and many of these players have not been at that competition. So they're an unknown factor in some ways, and they do have to make their stamp here to get that reputation built. And I do believe if you go out with confidence, doesn't matter where you play, if you're playing in a club game or a provincial competition, that really does send a message to the opposition, and she's trying to send a message tonight. Cathy Borst with another win.
Six-year-old Madalena Brulu.
Okay.
So take a look at the other games on the ice in this women's swift draw. USA and Kerry Erickson from Bemidji, Minnesota, look for their first win. Scotland coming off a disastrous loss. Germany and Denmark, the two unbeatens, are hooking up here in draw five, and Japan looks to win their first against Sweden and Elizabeth Gustafsson.
Well, Kate threw the first rock through, and then the rocks were in the rings, and so we've just been up and down the rings. Really nothing to comment on. As you can see, nothing in front, nothing in the house.
You know, it's a funny thing now, Linda. You and I both talked to Cristina Lestander. She taps the 12-foot. She goes over and puts the brush down in the middle of the four. She's probably never done that in her life.
Well, not in Switzerland, definitely. If she's traveled and played, she may have to do it a little bit. But in Switzerland, if you, for example, take the Bern Curling Club, where the very big Bonspiel in January is held every year for women. Basically, you take about a foot of ice for a draw, and you put the broom in the middle of the rock for a hit. And it's changed a little bit because they have Canadian ice makers going over, but that's very often the conditions they face. And so to read ice that has this huge amount of swing, as Ray has told us, requires anticipation of brushing all those elements. It's a very different situation for Cristina.
Heather looks solid this morning as well. So she's a very, very intense player, but a terrific team player. Very quick not to blame anybody, blame or take the blame on herself, when she feels that she's either turned it or
and made the error, and that makes her a great team player. Very supportive of her teammates, and she's very intense. She's really into the game. The slide.
Selena Brulou.
Planting the thought, we did see in the morning game when they had takeouts that required quite a bit of ice. Both Heather and Cathy felt they were a little bit inside on them. You do have to believe the ice, and you heard Heather say that this moves, the last one moved, I've got to believe it.
Yep. Hurry. Little roll, Kate.
Nicely iced, nicely thrown. Outside, inside out. Heather's the out turn. What a foot of ice for this shot. And if you're drawing into this area, you'll look for 5 feet of curl.
When you see curl like this, Ray, was this more the kind of thing that you would have seen during the Corn Brew era?
For sure, Vic. I mean, there's no question.
We
could, you know, we could take 6 feet of ice, and then when you added the fact that the ice would be affected by the chafe and stuff on the ice surface, you'd be taking 2 feet of ice for a big weight hit. It could look awful bad, boy. There was the periods changed a lot. The ice went from, from very, very a lot of curl where you could really, if you ever turned the stone, you were always better to throw it inside out. And then all of a sudden the ice got so straight, if you ever threw anything inside out, you were really penalized, so the ice got so straight. So you really had to change with it in the mechanics of your delivery.
And as far as average percentages go in those shooting percentages, this is where there is the biggest difference between the players and the opposing teams. Cathy with the good numbers at 83%.
Top four.
Whoa.
Close.
Coming
into the center.
13-2. Top four. A nice phone call from home today. Talked to my son.
Good job, girls.
Talked to Janie, my wife, of course, and she was just telling me how she raked the lawn Sunday. Does that mean anything? That she was cleaning up the yard and I was here. But I thank you, Janie.
Yeah, well, it felt like 13.5. Yeah, 13.5. That's what it felt like. I'm off 300.
In her fifth appearance at a world championship, the native of Bern.
Dip! Fast, Hummet! Fast!
Okay.
I can throw yours.
Earlier today, we asked you, the viewer, to participate in our email. Okay. We want to know what you think, because we've had the debate about whether we should stay with Canada's games, first rock to handshakes, or instead, if the Canadian games get out of hand, one way or the other, a big Canadian lead or an opposition lead, and what you feel is no chance for a comeback, we should go somewhere else. So we'd like to know your thoughts. So email us. Let us know that you'd like to stay.
You haven't been down on the computer all afternoon, have you, Vic, sending a few messages?
No,
you can't do that, Vic. That's not fair.
And there's our web address. If you're by the computer, on the internet, let us know what you think. Stay or go somewhere else. And we have to admit, the early results from you has been predominantly majority.
Close
has
enough.
Been to go other to see other teams, other countries,
it's
other games.
Nice there. This guy, no. Oh, God.
Cristina taking the straighter turn for this takeout attempt, trying to roll out.
I'm looking down at the brush of Selena Brulou. Has she got this little fluorescent head on her brush?
Yeah.
Yep.
Is that something you'd like your third to have?
Yeah. Oh.
Nice shot.
To get the blank here in the first, Switzerland and Canada. It's the fifth draw of women's play from the Riverside Coliseum on TSN.
Nokia discovery. Small words are hard to read, which is why at Nokia we make our screens big, so they're easier to read. Inspired technology with a human touch. Nokia, connecting people.
She says she forgives you, but next time, she's calling Allied. Okay? Okay.
Thank you, Canada, for making Allied the biggest and best in the country.
If you care, Simonize it. Get professional results at home with Simonize High Gloss Car Wax. The protection of Teflon in one easy step. Durable paint protection and a lasting shine. Clean and protect your entire vehicle with Simonize Gel Protectant, bursting with nutrient-enriched beads. Each application revitalizes, nourishes, and adds the lasting protection of Teflon. The Simonize family of car care products are available at Canadian Tire.
I want more out of life. I want to have a good time.
You're gonna have a good time.
We want to be smarter about the way we spend.
I want to make the right decision.
I just want to make a decision.
I want more out of life.
I just want to get a life.
I want to be in control.
I want to get more. I want to get what I want.
The new Blue American Express credit card. No annual fee, it lets you carry a balance, and you can get cash back on virtually everything you buy. So you can do more.
It's about comebacks, breaking records, dog legs, and dog woods. And it's about to happen again. First and second round coverage of the 1998 Masters. See it, live it, Thursday on TSN.
1991, David Smith won the World Curling Championship in Winnipeg. Can Wayne Bedard do it this year for Canada? This afternoon in the men's fourth draw, he played Denmark and Tommy Stern. And in the third, looking for the double, and he ended up getting one, and that had the Canadian fans on their feet. Wasn't the best game for Canada, but they survived. Stern trying the in-off, couldn't get to the button as Canada wins it 5-4 running. Denmark out of stones, so Canada wins their fourth in a row. Finland lost, and so they are at 3-1. Canada now the only undefeated team. Wayne Bedard 4-0. As we return to the women's fifth draw, and Canada, Switzerland. Switzerland with the hammer after the blank in one.
Switzerland tried to get a rock in position in front of the Canadian stone and try to make it a little more difficult for Kate to get rid of that rock.
Shot.
Swiss lead.
Is it take?
And looser. The Swiss, again, one of those teams, Linda, that has a habit of rotating their lead players.
Yeah.
Actually, Anique, I met the first year she curled. She came to a camp that I was teaching at in Switzerland, and that was only 8 years ago. She's done a tremendous job since then. Very competitive and very natural at that stage, and took to the sport instantly.
Yeah, you were saying that the first time you saw her throw, and that she just was like, and there are, when you teach, you really get used to seeing that, I guess, if you teach anything. You know, you see someone come out and they've never been on the ice before, and all of a sudden they just, they can do the fundamentals so easily. And you just know that their future is, if they work at it and put it all together, they'll be good at it. Because there are naturals, it's like everything else.
I don't know if it's, she's got to do this distinctive.
The rotating of players is always an interesting debate, because there are a number of European teams that do that, and some people feel it's difficult to come in and out of games, and other people do it on a very regular basis, so it's not based on your play. It's not like you're being pulled like a pitcher in baseball. But it's something that not everybody is sold on. The Swiss team believe that this is the way to approach it.
Come on.
It's interesting, has the alternating quarterback system ever worked, which would be a little bit similar? I mean, even though you're not switching your skips in this game, which is more like a quarterback, but has that really worked where, you know, they would switch quarterbacks on a regular basis? I don't know, Vic.
I'm trying to think if there ever was.
Sometimes goalies in hockey are treated that way as well.
Clean. Oh. Clean. Yep.
It's not the same as subbing in the same game either, because you start the game and the next game a different player starts the game and they stay with that player regardless of the play. So it's hard to equate to another sport.
Go back and, you know, back into those great Edmonton days where Warren Moon and Wilkinson. Wilkinson used to alternate, I think, a little bit. But
I was thinking of Clemens and Holloway in Ottawa. I'm not sure. But
anyway.
No, not every other series, certainly. Not that I can remember.
Yeah.
Jonah.
But you don't see the rotation at the back end, do you? I mean, they're in curling. The rotation is usually up front.
No, but what was interesting in that game earlier, we saw that Denmark switched their third playing against Canada today. And we didn't chat with them and ask them why, but obviously they have a philosophy as well to bring in a different player. Anders Soderblom came in for Gert Larsen at third. So it is done. Less often it's skipped, for sure.
Less than yours. Katie, right over. Hi, girl. Really? It's getting quick there.
Selena and her sister in their second appearance at a world championship.
Good solid mechanics. Heather has good and square always.
Well, clean.
Rock well in front.
Yep.
Goes with the straight arm. Keeps her body up fairly high.
My girl.
Doesn't force the chest or shoulders into an unnatural position. Has a bit of extension.
Good.
Straight down the lines. Concentration. Good grip, in turn grip, swing from the shoulder. It's a rock well out in front. So you looked at the swing delivery and you looked at the no swing delivery, and both of them very strong mechanically.
There was black bits in a string. Like bang, 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 bang. That's what I was cleaning up. It looked like rubber bits.
It's nice for Cathy to get some early draws in this game. Evening draws, we often do see a little more frost creep in, and although it's early in the game, it's nice to have some chances to find the feel for the weight. And then as you play, you can use the stopwatch to make small adjustments to that draw weight.
I think so, not sure. We're going to be running on center a long time.
Cathy's reason for playing this very defensively is obviously is based on the fact that she doesn't have last rock, Linda. I think that the minute she gets last rock, you'll see her force the game. And if she doesn't, I think it's a mistake.
Could she not force it, though, to try and get the stone back, the last rock?
Well, she could have thrown up rocks in front, and you mean try to score without the hammer.
Well, no, we'll certainly score without the hammer, but, I mean, maybe Switzerland gets their one, and now you've got the hammer back, and you can go for your deuce.
Yeah, well, that's what she's hoping, that Switzerland hits the sticks here, what she's doing.
Good job, you guys. Good
a couple
guys.
More shots to come here, but...
I almost felt like Cristina was thinking about maybe just playing down, freezing to it, or too late?
No, I think she was just thinking about turn, if anything. And Cristina made a little attempt to get in front of a stone in the house, not to put up a guard, but she made a small attempt to generate offense in the rings, and it didn't work out.
Did you have a good season this year, Victor? Did you get a chance to play much? Because we were on the road so much, it's really hard to play.
Canadian,
Dip.
Mixed team lost the club final, the Skins League.
Okay.
But I wasn't there very much, you're right. And that's why they did so well.
Maybe why they lost the final.
That could be, but you know,
Linda's
you're very
mixed
nice.
Team, Linda's mixed team won the final did. Without her, so.
They got to the final mostly without me, and they won the final without me.
Okay, nose control.
Still haven't seen my share of the winnings from that Skins League.
You're not about to either.
One of the things you look for in the focus and the confidence is the eyes, and I've always looked at Cathy Borst that way. She's got tremendous focus.
Hard, Cathy! Yep! Gotta go, gotta go! Hard, girls, right up! Hard, 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 hard! Hurry! Right up, right up. Good brush. Good brush.
Not the desired result. Good brush is right to hold it. Another blank end here.
The team does look a little more relaxed, which is important. The first game they came out, and Helena Block-Loverson was on a roll coming out of the Olympics, and Canada lost that game. Since they've been building the team spirit and all the things that are important to them. And they do, as Ray has pointed out, look like a bit of a different team, look like they're ready for the week.
And through it goes. Second straight blank here in this fifth draw of women's play.
Hi, everybody, and welcome back to TSN Tonight. I'm Darren Detition. We hope you're enjoying the curling. Let's stay on the ice, bringing you up to date in the NHL action. You get the Edmonton Oilers fighting for their playoff lives, taking on the Canucks, tied at one. Vancouver on a power play. Peter Zezlin, Brad May work the give and go. Canucks lead 2-1. Oilers come right back. Ryan Smith, great work in the wraparound. He pays the price, but gets the goal. You got to do it. They're tied for the final playoff spot with the Sharks. It's 2-2. Oilers keep coming. Dougie Waite to Fraser in the slot. He beats Snow. That makes it 3-2 in favor of Edmonton. They got 20 minutes left to go in Edmonton. As forementioned, the Oilers go into tonight's action tied with the Sharks for the eighth and final playoff spot in the conference. The Montreal Canadiens, they tied with the Capitals this evening. 2-2 is the final. Toronto and Dallas, 4-2 in favor of the Stars. By the way, the Canes beat Boston by a score of 3-0. That'll do it for now. We'll see you in about an hour.
In the news, excitement is growing over the new brake technology announced by Midas. When tested on yellow cabs in San Francisco, these new carbon metallic brake pads lasted 29% longer than ordinary brake pads. Cab owners are delighted, since they'll be spending less on brake repairs. They can now afford to spruce up their fleets.
New Performance Friction Carbon Metallic Brake Pads, now at Midas.
If you care, Simonize it. Get professional results at home with Simonize Gel Car Wash. Clean and enhance the shine of paint, leaving the protection of Teflon. Clean and protect your entire vehicle with Simonize Gel Protectant, bursting with nutrient-enriched beads. Each application revitalizes, nourishes, and adds the lasting protection of Teflon. The Simonize family of car care products are available at Canadian Tire.
When it comes to choosing the right motor oil, let's make something perfectly clear. Introducing three new oils from Quaker State, specially formulated for the vehicle you drive. Synthetic blends for hard-working engines and high-horsepower engines. A full synthetic for ultimate engine protection. Extra filtered with patented Micro-Q filtration to ensure your oil starts clean for a difference you can see and trust. So when it comes to protecting your vehicle, why take a chance? Quaker State. The choice is clear.
Two straight blanks, and Switzerland maintains control of the hammer as we play in the third of this fifth draw. Women's play. These Ford Worlds in Kamloops. And a center line guard.
And a very nice center line guard by Kate Horn just in front of the house. So it's more difficult to come around, and it can be used by Canada, can be tapped up.
Okay. Quick scene. Just go away, Kitty.
Kate Horn. Her husband Daryl is the coach of this Canadian championship team.
It well on the ice. She put a foot and a half ice, so maybe just need a little bit more because they're looking for the roll the other way, obviously.
Annie Gluson.
Let's look firm here.
We told you at the Scott Tournament of Hearts in Regina that Brenda Bomer was building her own house. Well, she just started moving into that house, moving in the first bit of furniture. She's thrilled with the results. She subcontracted everything, designed it on her farm.
And with a good roll here, she can start another house.
Very good.
Building a big score.
Yeah, I was just...
I can't sleep some nights either.
I know, it's right.
Nice roll. She's a tremendous addition to this team. She's a wonderful brusher. Powerful, you know, Kate is too, but Brenda is a tremendous brusher. And she's one of those players you really love having on a team because she goes about her job kind of so quietly, you know, and adds what she has to add. And it's a great combination. It's a good combination. It's a, you know, you got Heather. We saw her opening annex in the sliding that we did at the beginning, and she's very animated. And Brenda's a little quieter, but Kate's very technical. She's really on the splits and the. good combination.
It is. It's very distinct, their roles, which is often important if you have overlapping roles or if it's not certain who is in charge of what part of the game. Sometimes there can be confusion, but very distinct. You see Kate with the stopwatch, Brenda, as you said, a great sweeper, Heather with the enthusiasm, Cathy with the cool confidence. It's a tremendous mix.
Hello? Mine's going to be tight. We're on top of it.
Lots of weight.
Might be tough.
Communicate very well, too.
Where is it?
My fault. Sorry about that, guys.
That's the brushing. It's going to die. It's going to die in the house area. I talked to Hans about that. Hans Vichik about that. There's no question. The motion, the movement, the air, the motion that's generated in the house area is and with the in the colored areas and the paint is causing a little more frost in those rinks. And he and I talked about it. He says that yes, it's there. You're absolutely right. And I was just looking for some verification.
Yeah.
We certainly don't know, all those kind of things, but you can see it on a regular basis now. So you have to anticipate that, yes, it looks like the right way, but if we're trying to move this stone or get a chip off it, we've got to get on the brushing early. So that's what I was trying to point out in the reading the ice segment.
Madalena Brulu gets both.
That was a very nice shot, and that was anticipated as far as the little bit of curl that they saw with that shot. Good sweeping.
Heather Godverson, Linda, found her comments to you interesting that, four games in, they thought the team was still working on its chemistry. Good brushing will hold it up, and look at the little inside flip. You'd think that something like chemistry you wouldn't have to work on, through a season. You've built it and built it and built it, and you come here, but she says, through the first few games, they didn't have their chemistry.
You practice in between the national and international events. So between the Scott Tournament and Hearts of Here, you're out in the ice and you're practicing, but there's nothing like game competition to make you bring your level up. And you do have to find again the things that you did so well at that top level, because it's not necessarily something that comes naturally. And this, as I said, and Ray has mentioned, this is a team with very distinct roles, and they have to get those roles, the things that they do, back up to the top competitive level.
Third stones in this third. Still looking for our first point.
Pretty nice roll, though, Linda. Hang that on the corner. It's been mine, switching with last rock. There's been two blank ends. Just to keep in the flow and remind myself. I've had a pretty good week so far. Eh?
Yeah. Very good.
Haven't had the wrong team with last rock.
Yep. Whoa. Clean. Whoa. 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 Whoa.
I'm sure there are people there. What is he talking about?
Yes.
Stick out there.
And Heather Godverson rolls it to the edge of the
four. Yeah, I guess you don't want to do that, do you?
It's funny, one of the things I noticed the Canadian team still struggling with, and it's the one thing that I struggled with at the world events, is that sweeping behind the T-line rule, the different rule at the World Championship where the front end, when following through on their own stone, cannot sweep behind the T-line. And so the skip has to be standing there ready to take any rolls and that sort of thing. And it's so natural. You play how many games in Canada under a different rule, and suddenly you come here and we had to start yelling skip and up and all the different words to remind ourselves.
Okay.
It's moving a bit.
Yeah, they threw firm.
Cathy Borst makes her way down for her first stone.
The other thing we noticed is the teams have been a little tight on time. They do get the 75 minutes, but no timeouts. And like in Canada, and sweeping behind the teen line, it's the acting skip only. That's a skip until they go to throw their first rock, and then the person holding the broom finishes off. And the four rock free guard zone rule, unlike Canada, where no opponent's stone can be removed if it's lying between the hog line and the house until after the fourth stone at the end has come to rest. So two differences, opponent's stone. In Canada, you can't remove any. And in Canada, it's after the third stone that you can make those plays.
Yep, hard girls, hurry!
Brenda Bulmers on the left, Kate Horn on the right. for this first stone.
Right up. No roll, no roll. Right
Cathy
up,
Borst.
Right up. Good brush, guys. Good job.
And sits right there, T line edge four.
We have noticed a couple of teams short on time. Canada hasn't really fit into that slot, but there's been a few that have had to speed up in the last few ends because of the time shortage.
These first three ends we've played very quickly, though, so there should be no problem here. It's one thing Sandra Schmurter did so well was get her opposition into playing quickly the first three or four ends, bank some time. Knowing that sooner or later there comes some complicated ends and time to slow things up, and
yep.
It's always nice to have a little extra time. You're not conscious of the clock.
Oh, dip, oh, up,
oh, oh,
dip.
Oh, oh.
Hey, got caught in them.
Okay,
wasn't going to roll all the way, so they decided to sweep it a little bit and keep it on that side of center line.
Mm. Other line entlang, so kommen sie mit Rüsche Rand haben. Extrem, extrem.
Cathy would like to hit this stone and get the roll in behind this guard here to force Switzerland to draw for the single.
Takes his time to come over.
Softer. Yep.
Yep. Yep. Yep. Hey! Watch it! Whoa! Whoa!
Whoa!
Whoa!
Whoa!
Whoa!
And it will sit edge of the 12, but out of her hand when she says softer. That indicate light to the brushers?
A little bit lighter, but it didn't look like it actually when it came down. It looked like it had lots of speed. She did mention it would hang for a while before it broke, and when they got on the sweeping early, that probably held it up and didn't catch the curl as soon.
And you heard Heather say at the end, it's my fault. I got them on the brushing a touch too early. The brushers will react like that, though. I mean, I certainly always did, and otherwise brushing or sweeping. When the thrower had the weight in mind, and then as they release it, say softer, softer, that's an automatic reflexive move for a front end player to go quickly to the stone.
Another blank attempt.
And not this time. So Canada gets the Swiss to take one here in the third. Cristina Lestander will hand the hammer to Canada for the first time when we come back.
Your car is a high-precision instrument. Take it to AutoPro. With qualified personnel and state-of-the-art equipment, it's the expert on brakes, front-wheel drive, steering, suspension, and mufflers. All protected by AutoPro's national warranty. AutoPro, the largest network of car care professionals. So he thinks he saved some money. Well, next time I'm calling Allied. Oh, geez. Thank you, Canada, for making Allied the biggest and best in the country.
Another Nokia discovery. Small words are hard to read. Which is why at Nokia, we make our screens big, so they're easier to read. Inspired technology with a human touch. Nokia. Connecting people.
If you care, Simonize it. Get professional results at home with Simonize High Gloss Car Wax. The protection of Teflon in one easy step. Durable paint protection and a lasting shine. Clean and protect your entire vehicle with Simonize Gel Protectant, bursting with nutrient-enriched beads. Each application revitalizes, nourishes, and adds the lasting protection of Teflon. The Simonize family of car care products are available at Canadian Tire.
I'm the groundskeeper, and this is my world.
It all starts and ends right here.
Every day, I work at making this world a better place.
There's no place like home.
It's a good day to play ball.
Jays, Expos, day. Mariners, Marlins, Tigers, Yankees, Orioles,
We're nearing the midway point of this women's fifth draw as we update you on all the scores. Scotland and Norway are tied 1-1. Right now it's Germany and Andrea Schopp with the lead. They blanked 2-3 in that battle of unbeaten. Kate Horn, as Canada has the hammer for the first time. Switzerland forced to take one in the third.
And a nice stone out front by Switzerland, nice and close to the rings. They'll try and get around it, Team Canada will.
She actually wanted it right beside it, is what she called for.
It's really curling, it's why they're trying to sweep it by.
Yeah, that's fine. Good shot.
But this is what you thought they should do?
Yeah, there's no question. I think Cathy makes a big mistake if she doesn't, well, she had no choice but to either go around that or stop short. She actually called for it just short, but because, as Linda mentioned, because it curled too much, was on the stone, they then tried to get it by. But, yeah, I think it's a very big mistake if you play up and down the ice with this Swiss team. I think you have to force them. She has the hammer now. She gave up the single. You held your opposition to one, which is the overall plan. That's why you approached the first three ends the way you did.
Panic looser. Linda, how much more difficult are taps like this?
Actually, a fair amount. Guards and taps curl so much differently than the draw because of the way the ice curls late. So there you see, it's the amount of ice to call for is the most difficult part. Difficulties in reading the ice by both skips on those last two shots.
She tapped right there, and then she tapped my yellow rock.
Numbers a little bit down for Kate in the first few ends.
The call. Gonna come around that? Either that or I'll redecorate again on the red. What do you like? Either that or we can push the red one back a little. Yeah, we're not. We could hit it and roll here.
And they still got that there, though. Then we got a kind of a gore.
Yeah, I don't mind. I like that. Guys?
Well, you heard the discussion. There's no point us saying anything.
Just control.
Kate came into the game shooting 83%.
Yep. A little up.
This is an in-turn takeout or out-turn takeouts are close to 100%.
Hard. Sorry, Brenda. Hard.
Take ours.
Okay, that's fine. Shot. Normal.
Brenda's right on her average coming in, but those are huge numbers for the Swiss second.
And here she is, Madelena Brulou.
Yeah.
Hit this right on the nose.
It's tough double. You gotta throw it right in the crotch. I don't mind just hitting this one and rolling in either.
Yeah, if you do that, you're gonna come in high and ours. It'll be great. Normal.
Four. You certainly have to hit them, that is for sure. In this case, she's trying to hit the one closest to the center line.
And of course, the reason being they are in that control zone in front of the house, top 12 foot that you try and own.
Oh! Shot.
the area right in here that we call, we refer to all the time, and runs up into this area here. Try and control this. A lot of the plays in this area here. Keep it in front of the forefoot.
One of the things I mentioned about Wayne Mada, I said the game is curling, but he maneuvers the rock. Said Wernick's another one where they're such masters at setting them up in the control zone and then tapping them up, angling things, getting them in the right position to score a big end.
Adelina Rulu gets them both.
Work spin.
Come, Adler.
Get it in the nose is fine.
Mine
little roll.
In.
Numbers on the two thirds.
Goodness.
He's not. McCarroll was doing well for Canada and Wayne Mada. Graham McCarroll.
Now you go around.
Yeah.
Now you dump around there.
And now it's time for Heather. And will we see the slide? Sometimes that way, sometimes this way. Sometimes she just doesn't know which way.
Sometimes I look back at tapes and I'm kind of like, okay, Heather, what are you doing? But I guess I'm just so involved with the game. I sometimes when we go bowling, I'll do the same thing. I'll move my hips so that the ball doesn't go in the gutter. So it's just out of habit. I don't know it. And I think it's just in my way of expressing how much I'm enjoying myself out there.
Hard! Not sideways this time.
Under throw it a little bit, Linda, do you think?
Definitely underthrew it a little bit and maybe needs still a little more ice. It's hard to tell because, as I mentioned, it breaks late and as it's dying, it does most of its curling. Unfortunately for Canada, it's not even in a position to get tapped up. And Switzerland can get into that spot first.
Focus, concentration from the Swiss third here in the fourth.
Ocean? Water, curl it in. Whoa. Yeah, now hard.
Yeah.
Hurry. It's good, so.
Yeah, okay, sorry, mate. Good.
Interesting, she knew and she said it wasn't curling, so, and we've seen players get caught, Linda, in that you wait and wait and wait and then you lose it.
Yeah, that one, hard to say because I don't know how far they could have taken it, but if it has enough weight, if it has T-line weight, you almost have to just believe it's going to break and keep sweeping.
52.
Now we've moved over enough. Heather's now drawing around almost a center line guard, so this should be a spot they know a little better.
You got to anticipate it's going to slow up, and you got to anticipate the brushing.
Oh, goodness. Did that ever break? What a beauty by Heather Godverson.
Yeah, you're right, Victor. You're right on. That is a great shot. Front of the tee line, fully buried.
Shoot, Nether?
Cuts across there.
What?
Cuts
across there.
I know. That's always mentioning, because that guard now was so close to center, they really did know that spot a little bit better, and they could put the broom in a spot where they knew it would come in, and boy, did it ever come at the end.
Looks like you threw lots more on the second one. 70 the first, 52 the second. It's a lot more.
I know that is.
From the center, it's dying with the curl.
Lestander will need all of that 90% here as she looks to run it back.
She's trying to run the center one back. That's right.
Yeah! Oh! Yeah! Freeze! Freeze!
Straight back, catch it. No.
Okay. Just had to get the brushing a touch earlier, didn't it?
How to get there is a problem.
Well, we took,
There's hung out there for a while, so we'll just take
how to get there. This is the hole here that they're going to try and go through. We'll just clear that.
Off this red?
Yeah.
More so than that yellow?
Well, it'll cut this way more. You better.
Top 12 is fine. Middle 12 is fine.
Right in the top 12 here. Okay. Like, just sort of show them half and half.
Right on, Cathy.
As long as we don't take it too deep and show them all of it. Yeah. You know what I mean? The line is more important here.
Right. Good comment.
I just want to cut off that raise she's got. Line's good. Whoa for line.
Whoa,
it's got to curl.
No line. It's got to bend lots.
Well, it's really got to move to find the hole.
Top 12.
Whoa.
No, just low.
Whoa.
And instead fills it.
That's exactly an example of why both of the ones that didn't curl had to be played about the edge of the 4-foot band. When they could move out because the guards were in different positions, that's when they got the curl. And that's the tricky part of this ice that you have to understand.
Right on. And it's hard to she threw that perfectly, Linda, and with the perfect weight, and it had just made a little move. They could have brushed it to hold it and taken it to the top of the 12-foot for a biter. But it turned out pretty well, because I think she took away, she did take away the raise. This rock here just came over far enough, you can see, to take away the angle raise on that stone. Now, she was going to try and do it by getting it here, take it away that way, show half of this one and half of this one, and that would eliminate that as well. But she got the job done just a little differently. All Switzerland has left is just come around, try and tuck one in here.
Einfach vorbei und ein bisschen etwas Gutes machen. Wie lang?
Where'd she go? Out nearly in the 12 foot?
Pretty close. She's trying to find the big swing from outside.
And the call has gone out for help, and so here comes Selena to join Sister Madalena and Annick.
Hurry!
Get it there? No, she's going to come up a little short.
Terrific try.
Sorry. Oh, not enough.
Sorry. Yeah. See half
of the stone.
I want to keep
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
No. 13. I got 13, 8, 9. They swept
too tough to draw this?
Well, they swept it the whole way down.
That you can tick them in.
Yeah. But we don't know what her kick was, right?
That, try that. We could knock ourselves out.
That I don't like. 7.
She can see half of this stone.
How about the angle? Can we hurt ourselves just tapping it up?
7 straight back this way?
Yeah.
It's probably safer, isn't it?
It's the best, I think.
Doesn't want to hit it on the outside or kick it over, but.
No, that way. Yeah.
I don't mind that. 7
back. Would chip it onto the one.
Yeah, I like that the best. We know what it does here.
The only thing we can't be is wide, I guess. Just clip it in or something.
No.
See, we can't angle the yellow too much. Or
just control.
You can see more than half of it.
You can throw a board if you want.
No, I like control. It's easier to control.
Moore's measure.
Okay. Give me ice.
Okay.
Gonna play the raise, Linda.
She did look at the three options, tapping the one directly, coming off the red one on the side that's outside the rings, decided in her mind both of those were a little bit dangerous and that the safest one is the run back.
I think it's the hardest one, though.
But despite the fact she can see, you know, more than half of that red stone that was just thrown, is it the fact that there is so much curl and there's so little weight by the time that stone gets there to move it? Is that her thought?
Well, to go out wide, there's so much curl, but that play would be down that straighter spot, okay. So she's not sure of the ice. That's what I'm thinking.
Horn. Palmer trying to hold it up.
Whoa. Sit.
Yeah, you don't want to touch it.
Shoot.
One yellow. And one for Canada here in the fourth.
Thanks.
It's real hard there.
Yeah, I know it is. I thought I had enough ice.
Yeah, the ice, it's been fooling both skips.
When AT&T Canada started this Dime Time thing, I said to myself, Dime Boy, you gotta be a part of this. Call anyone in Canada any evening, any weekend, for a dime or less. Who needs the phone? Dime Time, someone you love, okay? I'm no hero. I'm just trying to get Canada talking. One dime at a time.
New Dime Time, only from AT&T Canada.
I don't want to play this. The way the threes and fours and fives are going this game. Huh? Real hard for
life. Real hard!
Hard, guys.
Real hard! Hard, real hard!
Next March, Canada's best curlers and best curling fans will unite in Edmonton for the last shootout of the century. Take the first shot now at the best seats in the house.
Nokia discovery. Small words are hard to read, which is why at Nokia we make our screens big, so they're easier to read. Inspired technology with a human touch. Nokia, connecting people.
If you care, Simonize it. Get professional results at home with Simonized Gel Car Wash. Clean and enhance the shine of paint, leaving the protection of Teflon. Clean and protect your entire vehicle with Simonized Gel Protectant, bursting with nutrient-enriched beads. Each application revitalizes, nourishes, and adds the lasting protection of Teflon. The Simonized family of car care products are available at Canadian Tire.
We're in Kamloops and a drive down Victoria Street on a beautiful spring night. Well, this is a big game, too. The two undefeated teams, Germany, Andreas Schopp, Denmark, Lena Black Larvesen, both world champions, hooking up in this fifth draw as they play in the fourth end. And it is 1-0 Germany. That was gotten by Schopp. With hammer in the first, they blank the second, they blank the third. Final stone for Helena Black Larvesen and Denmark.
This was a wonderful end. She just turned this end around with a great skipping call. And you can see the situation in the ring. She's lying three, she taps this up for four.
Every stone in play. Four for Denmark and a 4-1 lead. Boy, oh boy, that silver medal. Turn that team and turn that country on as we go to take a look at Sweden and Japan. They play in the fourth. Or pardon me, Scotland, Norway. I'm sorry, I looked at the wrong sheet. I'm sorry. 1-1 as they play the fourth. Final stone for Kirsty Hay. Scotland at 1-3. Norway and Doherty Nordby, 3-1. Draw for two. And Scotland has the lead, 3-1. Finland and Jana Jokola, they won their first today, and they lead the USA. And there's Japan and Sweden. I just got there a little early.
Stand in the corner, Vic, please.
Thank you. You won't hear me now for a while. 1-1, Switzerland and Canada, and the Swiss have the hammer back to play this fifth.
Well, a chance for two. Linda, I didn't think that the outturn tap back of the shot was that hard, the one that was one quarter covered. I mean, and she was worried about ticking it over, but you really had to throw it badly to hit it out there and tick it over. I mean, you could play that with a light hack weight or back 12-foot weight and just tap it back. Maybe it was a tricky spot, and that's probably why she went to the shot she did. But the shot she tried was a lot more difficult, I think, personally, than the outturn tap back to get the two. You know, it had been covered more. That's differently, but it was showing pretty well.
I think you could have tried to play that hack weight, because that's the one I think you could have tried that tighter ice down that straighter spot. And if you wrapped on the guard, happened to tick it, you wouldn't have done any damage.
Exactly.
It didn't work, and we have lots of rocks in front of the house. We have that four rock rule in full effect this end. But now Brenda Bomer can play the hit. Look at this one go.
Oh, soft.
Okay. Soft?
Soft. I think that was a combination, that bad combination we call light and inside.
My mom!
The brusher's nightmare.
Now, with that little bit of frost on the side, the Canadian stone hung on the edge. But the control zone is what Cathy was more worried about, and that yellow one, the biter, is what Switzerland's going after.
Yeah. Hurry! Hurry! Hammer! Fish! Hurry! Fish! Oh.
And they won't get it by their own guard.
Oh, Florida.
So a couple of errors by one by each team.
Tap up.
No, because then they'll tap up.
I'll come around that one.
I'll come around three. Yeah.
13-5. It's busting down.
She's taking the edge of the 4 foot to get around a rock sitting right on the center line. Now we'll see if the ice has changed at all from practice session. That was the ice they were taking for the button in the practice session.
8, 12, 8, 5, 8, 5, 12.
And here it goes.
And you have to anticipate this brushing. Yeah. You know it's going to go.
Whoa, bump. Can we split it?
Split.
Whoa.
All right, so what do you do there? You just, the weight would probably take it top eight. So do you hammer it past that point? You saw where it started to break, maybe just past the Ford, maybe, you know, two-thirds of the way down, then it starts to move, so you brush it past that point and then let it break?
You got to anticipate it out early in the center of the ice surface. Nick, don't get me wrong, it's not an easy thing to do, believe me. It's very difficult to do because you're looking at it, you've got the feel for how heavy it is, and that looked like it had enough weight in the early part of the... But you just know that it's going to dig in and going to go sideways. I mean, it has been doing that. And the closer it gets to the rings, where that, you know, air circulation motion and there's more frost, they seem to be digging in a bit. Then there's the odd spot out there that slides on you, you know. So it's not easy. I mean, it's easy for us to sit up here and talk about it. That's the easy part.
When that came across the face so much, you looked for the double and just got the one. Now, once again... Now she's going out farther.
Taking a little more ice.
One thing as a player you really do have to watch, though, and that's give her the clean release. Make sure you get out to the broom and nothing with the hand, bring it over the top to get inside. That way the brushers can get a better feel for if you've got it cleanly to the broom. They can take it that first portion, then let it break. And it's a combination that's tough to do, but it's really important when the ice moves this much.
All right, take me through this then. Watch, tell me where they should be brushing this now. If we're going to assume that we have to brush it through a zone.
Well, they're judging the weight at this point, and they have to decide that, okay, the weight's close, then we have to go like H to try and get it by. Oh, so
no, they did.
They did.
What a beauty.
And they picked it up a little earlier that time, believing the fact that the weight was close. So they held it. And they know, I mean, it looks heavy out there, doesn't it, Linda? And you don't want to brush it, but you just know that it's going to dig in. Great brushing. Great brushing.
I used the broom and took it down for you.
Brenda Palmer and Kate Horn.
Don't put that back on. You'll need
And look
it.
At the pressure, in particular with Brenda Palmer, who's right close to the stone, and how the bristles are bent out of shape, and they drag it by and right to the lid.
And they've changed to the hairbrush that they were using the synthetics earlier. Yeah,
a little slide, a little motion, and that one, as she said, didn't end up in the gutter. That's a beauty. That's a strike.
Oh,
what? Yeah.
For sure, that's clear. It was a lovely shot.
So Lena will try the double.
Tip! Oh! Tip! Whoa! 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 Whoa!
Drive it back. Catch piece. No.
Cass?
Hog line violation on the last stone throw.
Oh. Is that this one?
Just about, yeah, this you can remove this. Something like that.
Just hang on.
You go.
It's your turn.
I think it was. Where was it?
It was.
Oh, no. Perfect.
I know it wasn't quite lined up.
That looks about right.
No.
That looks about right.
Yeah, it wasn't quite lined up.
Yeah, I would say more over.
It's your turn.
Okay.
Looks good to me.
Yeah, I thought so too. Oh well, Cathy moved it over, that's fine.
Selena Berlou has her stone pulled on the hog line violation.
Okay, I gotta be left. Well, I mean, same, just
close.
You guys
close.
Need to pound it.
Short's okay.
Okay, let's go short then.
Gotta work it.
That's light.
Help!
Well, that's a break for Team Canada.
Help!
Very big break.
What's this?
Hard!
Hard! Hard, girls. Okay, got to bend. Okay. Let it bend.
Let it bend.
Yep. Hurry.
Holy cow, we took that long ways. Didn't catch the screw.
No.
The difference.
Slider?
It has to be. Hey?
Oh, yeah. Referring to the stones, Heather thinks one of her rocks slides more easily. They're getting a different interval time back line to first hog, and so that means that they feel the stone is just a little bit different, and she has to throw it slightly differently as well.
Sorry.
What?
Oh, is it 57 and an 82? That's a drastic difference.
Yeah.
So after having her first stone pulled, Selena Berlou refocuses.
Yeah.
Clearly released this time.
Fish! Hurry! Fish! Hurry! 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 Fish! Whoa!
Oh, that's always.
Hey, down in front, you see?
Huh?
Start beside you. Yeah, that'd be good, because then if we can sit right here.
Yeah.
That one should stop us from rolling too far, too. Okay, let's move it a bit.
Well, no, this one ran straight.
Oh, I see what you mean.
Remember?
Don't tell it that we have.
This one's straight. This cuts. This goes straight.
Not really. I've seen a few come across there.
Lately, though?
Yeah.
But,
You can see Heather's, feeling, because as I keep saying, the edge of the forefoot, those pieces of wool that they used to string down to show us where the edge of the forefoot is, that is normally the straighter spot. It's not because of the line. Something about the scraping pattern or something else is making it a little bit straighter.
The call.
Shoot, that took off, eh?
Good shot. Yeah, you're right. Good call.
Just clear it for a moment.
Bump it to the tee line.
Yeah, they're in a lot of trouble. This is not an easy shot coming off the spot that does curl.
Wird laut rufen, wie lang es ist, ha?
They bumped it to, is it over curled? And they'll push it through into the back edge of the eight. Remember earlier we asked you to participate. Would you like to see us stay with Canada's games from first stone to handshakes, or if the games are out of reach, either way, win or lose, do we go somewhere else? Watch the end of the Canadian games. This is the way we're familiar with Canada in the finals. Another comment, please switch to a competitive match, especially one that will impact on the playoffs. And we appreciate your thoughts. Helps us make the decision.
I got lots of weight. Play it back.
Yeah.
You just want tee line though, eh?
I don't know how heavy it is out here.
Like Heather looked like she threw lots on that draw. We just want to catch the corner
of it. So far, it's still overwhelmingly in favor of moving. 78%.
I wasn't going to say anything. I wasn't going to say a word. Linda and I like the move concept. The crew, almost to a full man, like to stay.
That was a very nice attempt by Switzerland to make that raise. It just wasn't quite the right angle. They are second shot at the back of the 8 foot. Cathy will try and tap her rock. Top 8 foot, top 12 foot up.
These are the kind you have to anticipate quickly and hold, because it's going to slow up in the house. You got to catch it on the outside.
Going for plan B now, rolling in.
Oh, plan B worked out pretty well.
Now if you try the double, they're lined up, aren't they? Lined up for a jam.
That thing went nuts. Huh?
I think so.
Oh, that thing went nuts. I couldn't believe that.
I can see, as Vic mentions, that they may or may not. Sometimes you get a surprise when you come off those stones, that they're lined up a little bit there.
But
it's a nice roll, because even getting at it is very difficult. You can only see a quarter of it. Big trouble.
Magnet, huh? Geht uns auch, geht uns auch mit, weißt du so.
Live update for you. Germany and Denmark as they play in the fifth. In the fourth, Denmark scored four. We showed you that. This is the final stone for Andrea Schott. Interesting. She's.
I think it lost its turn. Caught
something, boy, because that's a. Did she still catch enough of the eight for one?
I think she did, didn't she, Vic?
So she gets her one, and they'll go to the fifth end break. Denmark up 4-2 in a battle of the undefeated. Two teams at 4-0 coming into this fifth draw. What's the decision here? Draw?
I heard raise again, but they've moved the broom out, so I'm not sure. Maybe just a draw. She looked at lots of things. You can definitely get the yellow ones off by the back red one, but I don't know if you'd save the shooter if you did it in his raise hit. There's not much open to begin with. She is playing the raise. Oh, what a terrific attempt, just a little light.
And it'll be a steal of two for Canada. Here in the fifth. So a great draw, nice hit and roll, resulted two for the Canadians. Fifth end break, Canada's up now, 3-1.
I can't believe that I curled that much.
Well, I thought there was something, I did something.
Next. Another case of boredom twitch syndrome.
Nothing relieves boredom twitch syndrome like Star Choice Digital Satellite Television. Over 90 channels of movies, sports, and entertainment. All with cinema quality picture and CD quality sound.
Honey, our favorite movie! Oh, thank you.
For a retailer in your community, call now. Finally, the choice is yours. Star Choice.
In the news, excitement is growing over the new brake technology announced by Midas. When tested on yellow cabs in San Francisco, these new carbon metallic brake pads lasted 29% longer than ordinary brake pads. Cab owners are delighted, since they'll be spending less on brake repairs. They can now afford to spruce up their fleets.
New performance friction carbon metallic brake pads, now at Midas.
Since 1982, Scott Paper has been the proud sponsor of the Scott Tournament of Hearts.
That's right, Gavin. Scott Towels has been there for the spills of victory.
And Scotty's was there for the disappointments of defeat. Oh, that was a tough loss.
Here's Sandra Schmerler and the Scott product team practicing their winning form.
What great action! That Scott team really delivers!
That was great. As always, the Scott Tournament of Hearts is brought to you by this family of fine Scott Paper products.
Started with a pair of boots. Kodiak boots, actually. And it just grew from there. It grew from boots to shoes. From shoes to clothing. Everything to dress you up or dress you down. Oops, not that far down. You could say that wearing Kodiaks has taken on a whole new meaning.
If you care, Simonize it. Get professional results at home with Simonize High Gloss Car Wax. The protection of Teflon in one easy step. Durable paint protection and a lasting shine. Clean and protect your entire vehicle with Simonize Gel Protectant, bursting with nutrient-enriched beads. Each application revitalizes, nourishes, and adds the lasting protection of Teflon. The Simonize family of car care products are available at Canadian Tire.
It is a nice night for a walk along the Thompson Riverfront here in Kamloops. Canada 3-1 after five. The Mad Hatter. Canada supporters. Our game is in the fifth end break. USA Finland just underway, tied 3-3 as the Finns look to win their second. The U.S. winless so far. Kerry Erickson from Bemidji, Minnesota. Germany did get one in the battle of the undefeated so far, and Sweden has come back with 1-4, a steal of 1-5 to tie Japan. something to eat and some coach's words to chew on for Canada.
Hi, everybody, and welcome back to TSN Tonight. I'm Darren Titian. The National Hockey League's regular season is winding down, and fighting for their playoff lives are the Edmonton Oilers. Tonight, they were in tough, I mean real tough, taking on Vancouver. It was 1-1 when Zezel and May worked the give-and-go. Canucks lead it 2-1. Oilers come right back. Ryan Smith, great work in the wraparound. He pays the price, but gets the goal. The game is tied at 2. Edmonton keeps coming. Dougie White to Scott Fraser in the slot. He beats Garth Snow. Oiler fans will rejoice because that happens to be the game winner. The Edmonton Oilers move 2 points ahead of the idle San Jose Sharks for the 8th and final playoff spot in the Western Conference. Elsewhere around the National Hockey League, Montreal and Washington. This one goes into the books as a 2-2 draw. Critical game for Ottawa this evening. Carolina beats Boston 3-0. The Canes are now just 2 points back at the Sens in the East. That'll do it for now. See you in an hour.
When AT&T Canada started this Dime Time thing, I said to myself, Dime Boy, you gotta be a part of this. Call anyone in Canada any evening, any weekend, for a dime or less. Who needs the phone? Dime Time, someone you love, okay? I'm no hero. I'm just trying to get Canada talking. One dime at a time.
New Dime Time, only from AT&T Canada.
You don't choose to have an accident, but you can choose your repair center. More than 1 million Canadians have relied on AutoPro, the largest network of automotive professionals. AutoPro Collision, a courteous reception. Professional repairs. Qualified technicians, specialized equipment, and in addition to AutoPro's national warranty, take advantage of our deductible protection plan, AutoPro Collision. People you can trust.
If you care, Simonize it. Get professional results at home with Simonize Gel Car Wash. Clean and enhance the shine of paint, leaving the protection of Teflon. Clean and protect your entire vehicle with Simonize Gel Protectant, bursting with nutrient-enriched beads. Each application revitalizes, nourishes, and adds the lasting protection of Teflon. The Simonize family of car care products are available at Canadian Tire.
The 1998 Ford World Curling Championships on TSN are brought to you by Ford Motor Company of Canada Limited. By Star Choice, Canada's leader in digital satellite television. And by AT&T Canada. AT&T Canada, it's all within your reach.
Swiss skip. Cristina Lestander finds herself down 3-1. And so it's time to check the numbers after five, brought to you by Simonize. Linda?
Well, in a very close game and a well-played fifth end, actually, by Canada. It was unfortunate. The hogline violation really cost Switzerland. That steal of 2 points is so big. They will have to regroup, and you'll see, again, the numbers are interesting. The draw percentage is lower than the hits. Both teams, that's how they came in. That's how they're staying, and that is the thing. It's not just, of course, the weight. It's finding the line into the house that they're having trouble with. But Switzerland will have to really rebound after that unfortunate call, as I said, in the fifth. And the two-point deficit, which is not hard to get back with the four-rock free guard zone rule, but you've got to get those rocks in behind those guards.
All the way, guys. Pull in.
Good brush, you guys. Good brush. Nice brush.
Girl.
And in they come with Kate Horn's first. Like this call?
No, I wouldn't draw down to the face of the one in the house. I would put up the guard. We're seeing lots of curl and lots of opportunity to get round rocks.
I agree. I play the corner. This is a way of generating offense. It's just, not as good a way when you get it, when they give you the rule. It's like utilizing the rule or using the rule.
Yeah.
Boy, this ice is. There's great brushing ice and great anticipation. You need the anticipation on this ice. You have to believe in the curl or believe in it, know where the odd straight spot is, and then you have to jump
just
in.
Just tap it back.
That was a nice shot by Anique, put into the position her skip passed her for, and we're going to see another one of those redecoration shots, trying to change the angle so that the Canadian stones are not protecting the red Swiss stone by sitting behind it.
Kate was with Cathy in 1995.
Whoa!
When they lost the Scott final.
Back 12.
To Connie Lalliburg.
Yeah, coming down.
Whoa!
No, back 12.
Back line.
No.
Back line.
That's the one spot that runs pretty straight. We've seen that about two or three times, Linda. But it got it off the face, which is not bad.
Is that too much?
25.
And you'll notice that Cristina, the Swiss skip, did not sweep that Canadian stone very hard as it was coming behind the tee line. That's because she may use it later. She may freeze down to it. So that was a wise move.
She's just freezing into the face again. And a good call. The situation now.
You've
got a rock behind the tee line. You've got the second shot rock. Very little rotation on this handle. So it kind of walks over there. Good call and a good shot. Very nice shot. Doubles there.
Straight up. Just catch this one, Skinny. Just skinny it.
Just couldn't afford to bump it.
Heel.
No, the angle is such that Canada, Brenda, can make a play on these.
She's got about 480 acres south of Edmonton. And a brand new house. Brenda Bomer. Got it. Oh, beauty.
Got a girl.
Very nice, Brenda Bomer.
It just sat, the Swiss stone just sat, and that was the worst spot for them. It looked like a great shot. She just moved it too much. Great shot by Brenda. Lovely shot. No mistake.
Of course, the problem for Switzerland now, after trying to generate some points by making those top 12-foot freezes, is Christina's worried about those rocks, and that's why she feels she wants to hit them. And you hate to be hitting when you're down two and looking for an aggressive end.
But that's a good call. She's only down two, Lou, eh? So
definitely. That's the problem, though. If you've tried to build things up on the sides and gets a little complicated, it's not such a worry. It's a big worry when it happens to get messy in that top 12-foot near center line. There's lots of separation between the red and the yellow at the top of the house. You have to be careful of the angle onto the back one. Looks like it should be okay.
Whoa! Whoa! Right off! No! Nothing! Yeah! Kick it!
There's a jam I was talking about.
And they do, and it sticks around.
It's too bad. It was just too thin.
Madalena is just completing her studies in microbiology, and she'll then go on for her doctorate, hopes to get into cancer research.
Good scrubbing, good brushing. And the deuce is set up now. If they can exchange the stones, Heather needs to get the roll over in front to try and make it a little more difficult.
Heather works for the Society for the Retired in Edmonton.
Yep.
She's a
quack.
in their fitness and rehabilitation area.
Hurry! Okay. It's fine. Got.
Looked for the roll, didn't get it, and sits top 12.
Tough one, Brad. Tough one.
It is getting to the position where, with each exchange, the stone is creeping out of the house. That might become a factor in the way the end is called.
This will still be in, though. I think you can be hit on the nose, don't you? Remember?
I think it'll be, a biter.
Yeah, she took a look at it.
Selena is studying pharmacy in Basel. This afternoon, the men played their fourth draw, Canada, in a game where they still weren't altogether sharp, but won 5-4. Norway wins, hands Finland their first loss. David Smith's a winner over Australia. Switzerland, Sweden win as well. And so Canada now the only undefeated team with four straight wins. Wayne Madaw. And we'll see him at 1 p.m. Eastern and 10 Pacific against the U.S. and Paul Pustervoor. Heather Godfrey.
Come behind us anyway. Yeah.
Well, maybe not. She may draw to, she could draw to the open side too, Lyndon. Just continue to get her 2 points.
That's what she's asking her team. And one of the reasons you might think of doing that is just the difficulty you've had getting the round rocks that tight to the house.
Okay.
Are you all right?
Thanks for asking.
Well, your chair went. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
All right.
The chair might be hurt, but Ray is unscathed.
I almost rolled off the edge here. I agree, Linda. Canada's going to be hitting regardless. I just think in this case, when you know, the two is so important here, I'd spread them out, go way over the other side. If they get a roll on you, it's a heartbreaker. But if they get it back behind the tee line and they get the roll, they'll be behind the tee line. Then you could come down on top of them or get to the round around your top center line guard.
And that's what she's decided to do. She's decided to draw away from the guard.
Got to make this, though. Can't be light here.
Oh, and it's everybody now.
Took quite a bit of ice, too, so it's not pulling away very much.
And they're going to come up light.
Fresh.
I like this turn better, because at least you can, it's moving big, too. Yeah, a little more ice. It's moving good.
Cathy seems to have a much better read on the ice the last two or three games. That's what I was talking about earlier, and she's been very decisive in her decisions. And
okay, control weight.
She got, you know, the team got a very big break last end with the hog line violation by Switzerland, and they took full advantage of it. Okay. That was a big miss for the Swiss foursome. That draw.
Two-time Canadian junior champion, Cathy Borst.
Control!
Stay sweet. Clean.
Yep! Yep! Whoa! Yep! Yep! Hurry! Whoa, 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 whoa!
Clean!
Whoa! 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 Sweet. Whoa! I don't want to roll. Sit. Sit. Good shot.
And she will sit right there.
Okay, good one. Nice weight.
It's a good call by Cristina. She just to forget that one and try and get through the hole and
the bump or the drop.
Or the come around.
I think she's probably tapping it with that ice.
With that ice, she is. She could play the intern draw, which is a little tricky because it's running a little straight and it's near the center line, but she could play the out turn draw. She's going to play the raise.
Yeah.
Cristina works for the Burn Curling Organizing Committee. She worked on last year's World Championship Committee, and she's working with the committee trying to bring another World Championship back to Burn in the year 2001.
Just light, that's all.
Oops, sorry.
This email from Calgary, which of the women's curlers at these 98 Ford Worlds have won the most championships?
And we have the Swedish team with two worlds, and two members of the Norwegian team with two world championships.
It is a very experienced and worldly
field.
The interesting one, of course, is Denmark, because you see 1982 was when Helena Blok-Laversen won her world title, and we've mentioned that hadn't played perhaps to her potential in the years intervening until this year, the Olympics. Last year, actually, she started to play well, but this year at the Olympics, she really made her mark, and she's playing so well so far this week.
Yeah, that 1982 win was listed under Marianne Jurgensen, who was the skip of the team, but Helena did throw the last rock. That was the year that Colleen Jones was at the World Championship. In Geneva.
Hard! Okay, we're gonna split. Whoa, whoa. Sit, whoa. Okay. Wow, we got that in the day, Josh. Oh, too bad.
Could have had you off.
Yeah, we had hit a little more, maybe.
Huh?
Hit a little more.
Yeah.
We're trying to see if a nose hit would be shot rock. Should have to roll a little bit.
Langkraut. And it's through the skraut line.
Also, yeah, I should have.
Yeah, maybe should I twist.
So,
it's
good.
Yeah.
Is 20?
No, I don't think those hit would give them.
No, that's what they were looking at. And they're also looking at how the rocks might jam and where they might have to roll to ensure they were shot.
Yeah, we must look at it. Yeah, it's a bit in, but it hangs behind the nose, or a bit. I think it's a bit in, but good.
Yep, a little bit in would be good. And watch the one at the back.
Hit and roll and watch the jam. Right on, Victor.
Achtung!
And there's the shot to get the one for Switzerland here in six. Cristina Lestander cuts the lead to one. Canada has the hammer back when we come back.
And he thinks he saved a bundle on the move. Yeah, right. Ugh. Next time I'm calling Allied.
Thank you, Canada, for making Allied the biggest and best in the country.
Excitement is growing over the new brake technology announced by Midas. When tested on yellow cabs in San Francisco, these new carbon metallic brake pads lasted 29% longer than ordinary brake pads. Cab owners are delighted since they'll be spending less on brake repairs. They can now afford to spruce up their fleets.
New performance friction carbon metallic brake pads, now at Midas.
Started with a pair of boots. Kodiak boots, actually. And it just grew from there. It grew from boots to shoes. From shoes. clothing. Everything to dress you up or dress you down. Oops, not that far down. You could say that wearing Kodiaks has taken on a whole new meaning.
If you care, Simonize it. Get professional results at home with Simonize Gel Car Wash. Clean and enhance the shine of paint, leaving the protection of Teflon. Clean and protect your entire vehicle with Simonize Gel Protectant, bursting with nutrient-enriched beads. Each application revitalizes, nourishes, and adds the lasting protection of Teflon. The Simonize family of car care products are available at Canadian Tire.
It's about comebacks, breaking records, dog legs, and dog woods. And it's about to happen again. First and second round coverage of the 1998 Masters. See it, live it, Thursday on TSN.
This is the footbridge that leads from the downtown over the railway tracks to the Riverside Coliseum, the Riverside Park. As we get you caught up now in all the scores, past the midway point of this women's fifth draw here at the Ford Worlds in Kamloops. USA has moved ahead of Finland. Scotland, Kirsty Hay looking to bounce back against Dorty Nordby. Denmark looking to stay undefeated and hand Germany their first loss. And Japan scores 1-6 to take the lead over Sweden and Elizabeth Gustafsson. Canada with the hammer here in the seventh and leading 3-2.
Well, that was a nice final rock takeout by Christine Lestander. Saved the end for her team, got the little roll. But a nice come around by Canada has them in pretty good position. An equal try and corner freeze that rock.
Fish, it's a long low. Fish, it's a long low. Whoa.
Okay, see, it's clear. 14-3.
Is it on the ring? Get in there.
We
can go back, host.
Come on, here.
Kick. Kill them. Kill them. What did I have for kick?
72.
Okay. With a little add.
Yes. And then it'll come down. Let us take it.
Linda, they talk in sports about motor memory. In golf and baseball. Is that what,
just tight.
In effect, is this drive from the hack? Is
just
it the
tight.
Motor memory where they can adjust so well to 72? And that's the interval
not
times. Or 52. Is that basically what it's about?
It's a combination of the large muscle memory, the automatic portion of the delivery, trying to get it so that you can do that over and over. But the draw weight, the times, the translation of that is in the head and translating that into the delivery. And it's not an easy thing to try and teach either. That's why it is a difficult part of the game.
It's the speed from the hack that you're relating to, Vic, and trying to regulate that and understand
Ridley.
And feel that. It's a game of touch and feel, and you have to understand this feel. If you're using the sliding delivery, it all comes from this motion from the hack. How hard am I coming?
It's funny, when I was in Switzerland once, there was a gentleman that was trying to say one of the hardest parts of understanding your speed from the hack is the fact that there is nothing that really gives you a relationship. You know how you're going down the highway and there's the telephone poles going by and you kind of, your eyes tell you, well, this is how fast we're going. With curling, you don't really have that. And we use the stopwatches to try and get the feel for the ice, but it's just a scale now from hog to hog. These are the times brought to you by Karcher. Draw here is the hardest thing because it's 13 seconds in the frosty parts and 14 seconds between the hog lines in the center of the sheet. So that's why getting the feel and then moving from parts of the sheet to the other and maintaining the appropriate draw weight is more difficult, especially in the evening draw when the frost creeps in. But it's hard. You see, as you're sliding out, you're concentrating, focusing on the target broom, so it really is now a feel. How fast am I sliding?
Wait, okay!
Careful. Oh, take a look.
I'm assuming here we're talking about 13 and a half seconds for a perfect draw, so she can be close to 14 and still be in front of the rings.
Whoa, we're losing line. Whoa, Heather, awesome line. Can we sit on it?
No.
Quick?
Nice shot.
Actually, that's nice. Okay.
62.
It's a very nice shot.
A little frosty.
Could be me a sitaho, was mine.
Blue Jays go on the road to Minnesota with a couple of wins so far. Labatt Blue Jays baseball comes your way Tuesday and Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. The pregame show baseball tonight, and then the game from the Metrodome.
Huh?
Baltimore is off to the quick start in the East.
Ostana.
It's cleanup time. It's a mess.
Is that what she said?
No, that wasn't a literal translation.
You two are supposed to be helping here, you know.
I just know that if I was sitting in there, I'd be thinking this is a mess.
Nay.
There's that straight spot.
Catch something. Drive it across the face.
Books boot.
We've heard more comments from you about whether we should be leaving games once they're out of reach. I think you stay with Kennedy. You never know when Mada could have a five-ender.
To make it 15-2, is that what you mean?
And I want to see the next best game, no matter who is involved. And the Worlds give us that chance. 72% of you say, however, that it's good to leave if the game is out of reach, one way or the other.
73.
Stay close.
Because I think we should too.
The count Ray and I, that's right. Good looking shot here.
That's a great shot, isn't it?
Yeah, Brendan Bulmer.
And that was great anticipation in the rushing again. I hate to keep harping on that, but it's so important.
Yeah. Just by, says Brenda, but perfect weight and a nice job sweeping.
But you know, that's what it's going to come down to, isn't it, Linda? The keys, when you look at the who is ever going to win this, and if the ice remains this way, the keys are reading the ice, the anticipation of the brushing, and that's who you want to win this.
Well, I think you're making a good point, because we're not being critical of the ice. We're saying this is an ice surface you have to be very careful on, and that is a skill, and that is, you're right, to be a champion, you have to use all your tools and analyze the situation and use the ice to its best advantage.
If it's blowing on Thursday with a big wind and maybe a little bit of rain, is that going to affect the way you approach the Masters, the way you tee it off, how you play that day?
Oh, of course it is.
Of course it is. Of course, it's, and the players that adjust to that have some ability to be able to take those kind of hazards, those kind of things that occur,
no question,
and handle them better are the players that are going to score better. I mean, it's good ice, as Linda said. We're not, you know, it's just, it's tricky.
With my second one.
Okay.
Yep. The frost makes it tough. I mean, I sympathize for people have to play on the frost lines. We've seen in a number of events in the past, not a lot anymore because the ice makers are doing such a great job, but where, you know, you don't have a control of the air circulation, you have no air conditioning system, and to where you get a frost buildup you just can't control, you know, it's raining outside.
Where is it?
Nita!
Room!
Hard!
Hard!
Heather Godberson.
That's a good shot.
Jack.
Han far nu ofte. Müssen wir fahren.
Don't look at me.
Well,
I know. I just didn't. Linda, did you pick up on that?
I was thinking she was asking that. How much you could see, how much air there was by it, but I wasn't sure. It's a big mess. I don't know. You could try a couple of things, but you're just bailing. And there was a chance for Switzerland to get near the face of Shot Rock.
Then the team is falling off, and when it's vorbei, then it's there. Yeah, shall I say?
Open it up. If it comes by and rattles things around, we'll take it.
You playing the high one, or you try to pick the?
I'm normal.
Playing the high red one, she's saying, right?
Yeah. Well,
back into the pocket, try and make red.
I think she's trying to get by the very long guard.
Yeah, if she opens it up, Linda Wright, if she gets down to the face of the ones that are just outside the rings and opens that, that's fine. I think, but she is trying to play by the long guard, is she not?
Yeah, I think so.
Hurry! Fast! Rock back!
And roll it away.
Okay, yes.
Updating Sweden and Japan. Mayumi Okutsu from Tokoro playing Sweden and Elizabeth Gustafsson from Umeå. And it's Japan leading 4-3. And this is the final stone for the two-time world champion, Gustafsson. And drawing 4-3. And she's now in front 6-4 as they go to 8.
And that wasn't an easy draw. We're watching sheet B, which is a center sheet. The most frost is on the sides next to the stands, it appears to us anyways. And that's where you saw the Swedish skip throw that draw. So a nice shot.
A little bit.
There's no question we saw it last night in the Canadian game. In the evening draw, it starts to really have an effect on the ice surface. And it becomes more difficult, there's no question. More difficult to draw.
I think so.
It's where the ability to throw big weight really is a helpful weapon.
Well, it makes it easier for her, but
Trying to run the yellow guard onto the yellow one top, 8 foot, 12 foot area.
In their last comment, Linda, if we don't make it, we don't get anything.
The way the rocks are overlapped and things, this is very tough.
Dad!
Just heaving it from the hip.
Fish!
Cristina Lestander.
Fish!
Well, she has a rock maybe in position that she can raise up now, Linda, if Cathy doesn't take it away from her.
The yellow double.
Yeah.
She'll probably take that one, eh?
Do you want to hit 4 in and roll over?
Better.
It won't be third.
Better.
No, but.
We guard this up. How do we get
to? Or we can be short. All in, she has 7.
Like
I think that is.
If we hit that in. She can angle tap that red one in just for a second, eh? And we're gonna have one heck of a time.
We can roll our shooter over here. We might give her another shot off this one, what do you think?
Our choice is to split that yellow. And then she leaves us way out here. Now she can hit and roll, eh?
Yep.
As long as we don't roll the shooter too far over. Leave it high.
Yeah.
This is moving.
Actually, you could just skinny it and come over to here.
Well, the higher the better. Okay.
Yeah.
Like, I don't mind just tapping it up and leaving it there.
Yeah.
Okay, this is moving real big here. Yeah. So, out here somewhere.
Okay, short is fine.
Yeah. Yeah, we're just gonna tap it up, the corner of it.
Okay.
But we don't wanna roll the shooter over. Like, we just kinda wanna have it sitting there. Ren, what'd you throw out here?
And
It's kind of a nice situation for Canada. There's not a lot that Switzerland can do in this position.
Mine's good.
I'm a little surprised. The only she thought they she's trying to protect against the double. Considering the way the rocks are staggered, didn't you think she might try and take away that raise that's there now for Switzerland?
No, I thought Switzerland's first choice would have been to play the yellow stones because they're trying to protect in this situation. But you're putting in her in a position where she's only going to have probably the raise, so you have to be prepared for that.
What do we leave her? Anything?
Mom? Yeah. Oder los jetzt, wenn ich da drin haue, da. Da gehen die zwei und der auch noch.
Mensch,
der
hat nur Kraft.
Der hat den nicht. Ja, der stößt einfach da an, oder? Danke. Den musst du nicht rausnehmen, wahrscheinlich.
Hm?
Den Geld musst du
nicht
rausnehmen.
Nein, nicht. Wenn ich bin schon gar nicht alle drin.
I'm trying to see it, but don't point, because you always call it.
She hits enough of the red one. Okay, I won't say anymore.
I know, but every time you call it, they make it. So.
There is a double possible off the red one top 12 foot. I think that was maybe what Cathy was talking about, but Switzerland's going to play the race.
Awesome with the three. Wait, nur mal second, das ist wohl. Oi, oi, oi.
That's trouble in any language.
That says it all.
That's universal, is it?
Yep. I mean, I think she'd be happy, she said, to get there for the second.
Absolutely. At this stage, that'd be a huge shot.
Canada with the hammer.
You got to believe the sweeping here. You got to believe the brushing.
What a terrific shot.
What a gorgeous shot by Cristina Lestander.
And that's all she had, too. That's a lovely shot. It really is a good shot.
Well, you know, we talked about the fact that if Heather and Cathy decided on the shot they played, they only left really the one good shot for Cristina. And she makes a beauty.
Does she ever, Linda? Yes.
What?
And that's universal as well.
It was well swept, well called, and what a beautiful throw.
I can't see enough of it.
Wow, is that turning this end around?
I could punch this back right here. For one,
we have to hit half nose.
You like that?
They were going for three, and now they're looking for a way to get one.
I like this. We have nothing to lose. I can't even see enough of it, though. Look how much I can see.
No, it bests in there, doesn't it?
I can only see two-thirds of it. I need to hit it across the face.
But there's a long guard out there.
And even then, we're not getting anything.
Okay.
Just tap it up.
But there's a long guard out here. So just a tap back.
That busted pretty good at the end here, didn't it?
Yeah, I gave you more ice there. I give you more ice. I give you right here. That's where I gave you last time.
Okay, well,
a couple things. She's tapping this one back here.
That's how it'll go.
And she can tap it back. Even if she taps it to the face of that.
I know, but it'll still go.
She'll be shot.
So even if we come onto the back one, we're okay, right?
Yeah.
So after losing the final in 95, Cathy Borst. Wins this year's Scott, and she is here. And as she said then when she won it, finally.
It was like, you know, so many years that myself personally has waited to get to a world championship. As I say, we won two junior Canadians, but there wasn't a world at that time. So, you know, we've put a lot of time into this game. We've worked many hours, and it finally paid off, and it was really just a thrill. And I guess I didn't think about it till later on that night, you know, Team Canada, like we are all the things we get to do, and one of the benefits is getting to go back to the Scott, like without having to play through all those games. It's really fun. I'm so excited about it.
She had it perfect if they brush it. They had it perfect.
And it curled, and Heather Godverson said to her, it will move. And she didn't believe her. It did move, moved too much. So a wonderful angle raise by Switzerland, then Cristina Lestander. Results in the steal of one, and we're all even, 3-3 through seven.
Did you see the look on his face?
Hey, here comes another one.
Come to Papa.
Wait, not a Ford Contour. That thing's got more moves than a cat.
And it's so quick.
What do they think we are? Greyhounds?
Come in and test drive the newly restyled 1998 Ford Contour. One drive will surprise you.
Hey, you guys up for a little Italian?
Yes, it's boredom twitch syndrome. You're lucky. There's a new treatment.
Got boredom twitch syndrome? Get relief with StarChoice Digital Satellite Television. Over 90 channels of sports, movies, and entertainment, all with cinema quality picture and CD quality sound.
Hey! It's the Ottawa game! Thank you.
For a retailer in your community, call now. Finally, the choice is yours. Star Choice.
When AT&T Canada started this Dime Time thing, I said to myself, Dime Boy, you gotta be a part of this. Call anyone in Canada, any evening, any weekend, for a dime or less. Who needs the phone? Dime Time, someone you love, okay? I'm no hero. I'm just trying to get Canada talking. One dime at a time.
New Dime Time, only from AT&T Canada.
If you care, Simonize it. Get professional results at home with Simonize High Gloss Car Wax. The protection of Teflon in one easy step. Durable paint protection and a lasting shine. Clean and protect your entire vehicle with Simonize Gel Protectant, bursting with nutrient-enriched beads. Each application revitalizes, nourishes, and adds the lasting protection of Teflon. The Simonize family of car care products are available at Canadian Tire.
I had a great childhood, full of laughter. I want my daughter to have one too. But growing up isn't just fun and games. There's more to it than that.
Introducing the CIBC Smart Start Program, a unique way to help ensure your child has the brightest, most secure financial future possible. It makes banking simple, relevant, and fun for your child.
I'd like her to stay a little kid forever. But as a parent, I owe it to her to look beyond that.
Canadian Imperial Bank of Commerce, seeing beyond.
She had one shot, one chance. It is our Levesque key shot, Cristina Lestander.
You think of all the elements that had to be perfect for this, finding the right spot for the broom, finding the perfect weight to move a redstone onto another rock that you still have to move out of the button. This is just a terrific shot, and this is to save the end of possibly the game.
Good call by Selena too, Linda.
It was set up for Canada to score three. It turns out to be a steal of one for Switzerland and a 3-3 tie. As we go to the eighth, updating the other scores, Carrie Erickson from Bemidji, Minnesota, looking to win her first. I got Tokoro right now, though. And Sweden ahead of Japan. Can't say Bemidji.
There should be rules about that, though, because I have trouble with that one, too.
With Bemidji?
Well, sometimes. It's like some days, all the players should be named Smith, because I have trouble with names some days.
Well, you got that with the Scottish men's team, except for one.
Show the Scotland men's team every day, maybe.
Okay.
We talked about Switzerland having to rebound after giving up a steal and that end having a hogline violation that really caused them some problems. And now it's time for Canada, because it looked like in that seventh end they might get three. They might really go ahead in this game. And look at the situation. Now Switzerland's putting on a bit of pressure.
Good point, Linda. That's right. It's a sign of always of a good team if you can just, you know, regroup. And actually, to be honest with you, Cathy had a perfect shot if they brushed that all the way, her last one.
It was another one of those anticipating sweeping where Switzerland, as you mentioned, did it very well.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, in fairness to Cathy and Heather, it was an easy spot to pick up, but it had to be picked up a bit earlier.
Okay, whoa. That's a good shot.
That's a nice shot. That's plan B, but it's very close to being a plan A, getting rid of that front one.
Should we introduce that on the tape, plan A, B?
Plan for the vehicle.
On the next tape, on the update.
Everybody.
Yeah. Off the T-Rack. Sorry, T-Rack. Sorry, Dana. Can you bleep up? Can you bleep up the draw?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, this is an interesting call. They're going to hit the corner guard. I'm assuming try to roll in front of the row.
Whoa.
Madalena Brulu.
I don't like that call at all. I don't know. I keep the pressure on.
You want to draw in here or hit it and roll?
What kind of tie do you wear with a green jacket? Well, any tie you want if it's the Masters green jacket. And we have live coverage of the opening rounds Thursday and Friday of this week at 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 Pacific.
Want to play board weight? Easier to stick around.
Control. Bust hard.
Go get him, David Duval. He's in my pool. Marco Mira.
Control. Yep. Hurry. Hard. Right up. Hard.
Okay. We're nosing. Okay.
I think Switzerland had a chance to really keep the pressure on there, Linda. I think if they, you know, played a more aggressive shot than hitting that front one. They, you know, sometimes when you get the momentum switch, and she got the switch with that great shot, and Cathy, you know, couldn't make the raise for one. So I'm a great believer in really, you know, keeping it on. Yeah, it can backfire, but.
No, I agree. As I said, I thought that was an interesting call. It's not one I would choose, but try and keep it a little open now, I'm assuming.
I don't like leaving this here.
Pretty good numbers tonight by the players. As I said, the Swiss team in every position was a little bit below the Canadian rink.
Yeah. Yeah, I think so.
No.
Okay.
She doesn't like the stone here. I don't blame her. She can hit this and come across.
Firm.
Brenda Bomer.
Control. Firm. Nothing.
Bomer, Brenner.
Girl. Get out.
It won't get out over there. There's too much frost.
That's the one straight spot, and she maybe threw it up a little. The weight didn't look too bad. Just got it outside, I guess.
The biter hangs on, and Switzerland now will play the come around.
Also sieht die ruhigere Seite draus. Okay.
Remember, Heather was 100% earlier.
Tough to maintain that average, but that's a terrific number as well. Remember, some of the big numbers we're looking at are right behind the players, and that's the tie score after that terrific last shot by Switzerland in the last end.
Three.
Leopard forward now. Cosman now. See ya. Hurry. Whoa, whoa, rolling. Whoa, see ya. Hurry. Hurry.
They say
hurry.
Only wait, and then they realize this is just going sideways.
Okay, so
just a little light.
Boy, look at that. A great line.
That's a problem.
This is one of those spots because there's such a range of draw weight on this ice. It's one where you need more weight because the curl drags it off.
Front of the tee line.
60?
Yeah, 60, 65. Heather Godberson.
Room! Lots of room! Lots of room! Whoa, wide open! Whoa, 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 whoa. Where is it?
Got 12!
Whoa, whoa!
Gotta
whoa.
Go for 12!
Yeah! Yep!
Yeah!
Hard!
That's fine, right there is fine. 14. Didn't bend yeah.
Christina's trying to see if she could hit the yellow one and get some action pushing a red one in.
Can't really sleep in there.
Just make sure the angle wouldn't then jam it onto the biter.
What Lynn is saying here is to hit this one here and try and come across here, maybe push the stone in a little bit, but you have to be careful not to, when you hit it, drive it onto that one. It's tough.
It
looks a lot, okay. Lot like if you do hit it, a corner of it to come across and get the squirting of the red one in, Linda, as you suggest, it may jam.
Yeah, you may have to hit a little thicker and hope for just a nudge to a biter position, not the big push in.
Lovely shot.
Very nice.
She got it thick enough. She's absolutely perfect.
Top eight and buried as we peek in at the game between Germany and Denmark. Denmark leading 7-2 over Andrea Schott. And this the final stone for the skip from Garmisch-Partenkirchen. Both these teams
here.
At 4-0 coming in and looked for the angle raise. Gets nothing. And it's a steal of one more for Denmark. Here an 8 and an 8-2 lead. And it's actually a stone that was raised in by the German skip shop with her first one. So she gives the point away, and it's 8-2. Denmark and Helena Blackglavsen, and she will win it. Helena Blackglavsen and Denmark will go to 5-0 and be the only undefeated team remaining here in women's play of these Ford Worlds. Germany and Schott fall to 4-1.
What a great come around, Linda.
Heather Garberson just threw that come around draw to the, see it, the Yellowstone just about the tee line position. And the slider, Heather, she was trying to hold it from curling too much, and she was sliding right over to the boards because look at this go. Right now, you can just feel her down the other end doing that little motion to make it not go too much. And it's just a lovely shot.
Here you are.
To get
it
by the red one
shot.
In the house, like curled so much.
She was almost on the next sheet.
She was shot three times.
She was wondering, what's that girl doing over here? Christine is looking at the angle raises, but the rock's a little bit behind the tee line. You can draw to it.
Or just put it on the corner if you can.
A freeze, huh? When it is effish, yeah, it's good. When it is noch a little stoss, it's schon nett. Schon wurscht, wenn er nicht ganz. It's good.
She was looking at this, as Linda mentioned, coming down, hitting this onto this, and maybe catching this one here. But if she comes down and sits right in there.
Wengi.
Now it will start to walk over, and you have to know that. And it will dig in.
Well, they could have been on it a long time before that.
Yeah, they got caught.
And it seems to want in that situation, on that particular shot, it goes from what you think is a comfortable speed to stop in maybe 2.5, 3 feet.
It's very fast. I don't think it catches anything. Ray has talked about it. The painted surface and right in front of the house just has that extra frost. The friction is so high, it grabs at the stone and just stops it.
I know she's going to have a raise back something.
I talked to Shorty and talked to, we have talked to Shorty and talked to Hans and to BJ and to Lloyd Senzo and all those ice makers, and they say that there's so much motion. There's so much motion in that area with the movement of people and the air circulation and so on and so forth. That area gets warmed up by a little warmer, and the frost, even though it's hidden a little bit, you can see it. If you get down on your hands and knees, you can see the marks and the area, and just on some ice surfaces, some buildings, that really digs in there, and you have to really be careful.
Of course, if you're Canada and you saw the last end, you're realizing that the one nice thing for Switzerland is that stone can still be promoted, and that's what they're worried about. Canada thinking of trying to tuck a corner around that red stone.
Like half around this one would be good.
Yeah, you can see the frost in the blue. You can see it, how it stands out in the blue circles. It's in the red.
A little bit shinier on the white surface than in those other areas, that's definite.
Further out here,
Brent,
eh? Might be faster.
Where?
Might be fast
then
there.
Where? T-line, plus! T-line! No, plus!
We gotta be back then.
Plus!
Whoa!
Well, I wanna be here.
Still back.
Gotta be back, yes! Hard! Take it, Heather, take it.
Look at it go.
Take it.
Into that fast spot over there.
Yeah, I think so. Kato, good reminder. It's me. Good reminder.
Sorry, Cash, we should have been taking that rail all the way back.
Brenner.
It's very generous, again.
Well, she made a great raise in the last end, Linda. She could also tuck around it.
I think I'd be tempted just to draw.
Linda suggests, and I agree, get this rock right anywhere in here, and it becomes very difficult to get it by either one of these. If you ever got it into this area here, then it's almost impossible, other than a wean the dog peel.
And almost worst case scenario, if you came to the back one, Canada's forced to take a point.
To draw for one,
it's the eighth in, and you'd be looking in pretty good shape even so.
Freeze, huh? Oh. Oh.
Peeking into the game between Sweden and Japan as they play the ninth. You can see it's 6-4 Sweden. That's Elizabeth Gustafsson from Omeya. Mayumi Okutsu has a chance, a draw 4-2 in a tie game.
Lots, guys.
Team from Tokoro.
Lots.
I think she may be trying to tap the red one in the house, Mayumi, for three. It's difficult to tell, but by the way the broom is positioned, I'm just making the assumption it's not the cold draw.
I think so. I agree, Linda.
And the stone by Lestander is heavy and will slide past the Canadian stone at the back four. And now it's a draw for three.
Mayumi is playing the entering tap for that extra point for three.
They're really going to have to scrub just to get it by that stone in the top of the red. Now, if it doesn't, maybe they'll get the bounce in. And now, will it sit for the second point? No.
Heartbreaker. You know, that was a good chance for Switzerland to get out of trouble with that shot. She just overthrew it. And it's a perfect chance for Cathy Borst to get three now and take complete control of this game.
Oh.
Boy, look at it ride that four for the longest time, huh?
And that is where it's a little bit straighter and slides more easily, and that's what Cristina got caught into, and for Cathy, it'll work out all right.
And she plays to the back one, and those three yellows around the edge of the forefoot are three for Canada. Here in the eighth, Canada breaks it open. Now up 6-3. We're at the Riverside Coliseum in Kamloops.
Welcome back to TSN Tonight. Last year, the Edmonton Oilers made the playoffs for the first time in 5 years, and it was magic. Tonight, they're trying to get back to the postseason. You know what? They're in a life-and-death situation with San Jose. This evening, they're taking on the Canucks. Pavel Bure. Doesn't get much better than that. Shorthanded goal as well. It's 1-0 Canucks. The Oilers don't roll over. Down 2-1 in the second. Ryan Smith with a great effort. He gets a wraparound to go. He pays the price. But hey, he got the goal. It's tied at 2. Later, another power play. Dougie Waite to Scott Fraser in the slot. That proves to be the game winner. The Oilers are now 2 points ahead of the idle San Jose Sharks for the eighth and final playoff spot in the Western Division. Let's take a look at Montreal and Washington. This one goes into the books as a 2-2 draw. Sebastian Bourdais with both goals for Montreal. Meanwhile, it was Carolina over Boston 3-0, much to the Senators' chagrin. The desk in an hour.
The frozen north. Ancient home to the muskox. A curious pairing of land and beast. Out of place in the modern world. These brutes persist despite the shortest of summers. Witness the North's majestic mammoth as Nature Stories explores the muskox. Wednesday on Discovery Channel.
Welcome back, and we quickly want to go to the game between Scotland and Norway as they play the final skip stone in the ninth. Scotland leading 5-4 with the hammer. This is Kirsty Hay and her Scottish Women's Championship team from Perth. And this is a draw against two yellow stones. Top eight, back eight. And she'll get it to the four for her single to lead 6-4. Scotland comes in with a record of 1-3. Norway and Doherty Nordby 3-1. But it's Scotland up by two now, going to 10. Here in this fifth draw of women's play at the Ford Worlds. Getting late. And one game is in fact final. As we update you now, the USA looking to win their first, playing 10 and up by 4 against Jana Jokola. Denmark wins, and that should be reversed, the results. Germany should be 4-1. Denmark is 5-0, and the only undefeated team remaining. And Japan went for it all, trying to get 3, had to settle for 1, and trail Sweden 6-5.
bit of a heartbreaker. She threw that the rock for three very, very well, and it just ticked the front one. And what a, you know, what a big change in that game. You're hitting for three, and you know, to go one up, and now you're one down.
It kind of typifies their week in a way.
Yeah,
they've played pretty well. They've had a couple of things go wrong and a couple of close games, and you need the breaks to go your way if you're going to win a world championship, along with, of course, executing. And Canada did execute pretty well in that last end, although Cristina Lestander had a chance to get out of that end.
Yeah, golden chance. Golden chance. Get that rock, well, as you say, to the face of the other one, and then it's Canada's drawing for one. Or if you get it tucked around a little bit, boy, it's going to be tough to get out of there. You could steal a point.
Both thought that the game this morning against Japan was one that the Canadians regained some focus. Am I wrong to suggest that this game, being as close as it is or was until the three, and still may be, but the shots required, the thought processes, really gets this Canadian team in gear?
I think so. I think what they're learning a lot tonight are these changing ice conditions, and that's going to do them well for the week. I think they're picking up the spots now. And Ray said it best. It's Cathy, really, that is feeling like she's reading the ice and getting the feel for the weight, and as a skip, you really need that.
No question. Okay, Sean.
Pretty good little shot.
Okay, we jammed?
No, get rid of the
call. Okay. I got you.
Peel. Roll off.
Yeah.
Yeah. We might even get this one so that it helps to get rid of this one.
Yeah. Good call.
Peel.
Peeling.
Brenda Boomer.
Peel, big peel. Yeah. Walk.
Good try.
And across the face. The NBA on TSN this Friday at 7:30 Eastern Time.
Top runner.
Miami and the Raptors in Toronto.
Take out. Yeah.
Raptors have had a, by comparison to last year, a disappointing season, Linda. And all the changes, Grizzlies feel like they've been a little bit better?
I think so. I think they've been close in a lot of games, and just in the last few minutes perhaps losing some, but I think they've improved.
Trades haven't worked out too well for Toronto, Victor?
Well, I think they believe that the future is with that team, and they've done a house cleaning and gotten rid of players that may have been, you know, with the previous regime of Isaiah Thomas. So. They believe the future, they have a pretty good nucleus.
That's a nice
Let's
shot.
Try to just bump this a bit.
Really,
yeah, that's good. It's
just Cristina does have a lot of knowledge, a lot of experience. She'll try everything to get at least to this end.
States has won their first game. Kerry Erickson from Minnesota, Bemidji, wins and is now 1-4.
Bemidji, right on, Victor. You're just handling that unbelievably well.
And
Bemidji,
Finland, and Jana Jokola now 1-4 as well. Heather Godberson.
Got the weight. Hard.
That bedrock rolled into a great spot for Switzerland, didn't it?
Canada's trying to move things around and take the angles off.
Yep. Hey.
are trying to move the yellow one top 12, but this one's really curling. You heard Heather say that it was her.
Yeah,
she was a little inside.
Yuck.
Not so bad. It took away the angles.
Probably what? Has T-line back?
There's lots of time at the moment. That's what Christine is looking at, the time clocks.
You know her well, and she seems like a very nice person. The whole team seems really nice.
They are. I actually met Christina at when I was curling in the World Championship. She was translating for the various teams. She's a very talented young lady. Mm-hmm.
To do these were rearranged actually. Heather didn't like the shot, but it really turned out to be not too bad because there's no angle onto this one now. And you can't hit the red one just biting the 8 foot straight back. So. You could maybe play the yellow onto red, red onto red, and just to try and rearrange them a bit.
Or you could directly raise the red, that's what she's saying, and spill the shooter over just to try and open up the back one a bit.
Yeah, nummer T-line Langspieler. Okay.
Raise this one here. Push that way. Go over here, which would open this. It's perfect. It's perfect. It's what she called.
Yeah, it's a great shot.
26. Okay, we gotta get the roll, guys. Let's do it. In the roll. It busts here. I like control.
Control!
Yep. Okay. Moves.
Canada breaking it open with the 3-8. We would hate to give that back.
Yes!
Heather Godbrinson, Vollmer, Horn. You heard Heather say it busts here, and it really broke.
That bust. That was normal. I knew it. Darn.
Doubles there, so desires. I would play the double right now.
Enter the trein, legen oder das da mal machen.
Peeking in while we have a moment of the game between Sweden and Japan. Sweden leading 6-5 with the hammer. That's Elizabeth Gustafsson throwing her final stone. Japan is lying one. It's the tying point, back four. Japan, Mayumi Okutsu from Tokoro, looking to win her first. And right up on top for the point that'll make it a 7-5 final. Sweden wins it. And Gustafsson goes to 4-1. And Japan, Okutsu, drops to 0-5. And they're still talking about it. The Swiss, what to do We're talking about playing a freeze, Linda Ray, or maybe the hit and roll.
Well, picking up two is not bad in this situation, Vic. If you get two, you're down one coming home without Bass Rock. But I think I'd be tempted to maybe to play it now. You could play it quietly if you so desired, but.
Nuh-uh. Nee, we moeten aanleggen. Het is die nummer twee best, want die brengen we nu weg.
Christina's looking at all the angles. I would not play the hit and roll on the stone that's on the left, because you might be just rolling behind the other yellow one, and then it would be difficult to get that yellow one out. I would be making a play on the yellow one near center line. However weight you want to play it, however far you want to roll it, that's the one I would play. It looks to me like they're playing the other one, the one that I wouldn't play first. But they're going to play the try and get the long roll, which is tough with a straighter turn.
Oh, lang, huh? Sehr lang. Achtung. Ah, ich bin in der Bombe. Tappers, can I hit the
inside? Can I kiss it over?
Yeah. You?
Yeah, that'd be good if you can do that. The problem is, if you do that, then she's going to have a double, and then she'll be buried behind. No, I don't want to do that.
You got to get the roll. Sit over here, eh?
Yeah.
Even then, that's nice. Get the roll. Good call. Yeah. Firm? Now yours don't move like hers do.
No, I
control.
I think that should be all right.
She's talking about hitting it, first of all, and then pushing it a little over, but then if you hit it and leaves the double, then when you made the double, the rocks would be buried behind the front rocks.
Yeah, it should.
Stone is second shot.
What's Heather blaming herself for?
Well, the sweeping call, but I think it might have rolled anyways.
Jeepers. Sorry about that. I was thinking they're going to move on us, but they're not moving.
Yeah, we have to make sure we're second, though, right?
Well, I know, I realize that, but they were moving and I wanted to be moved. My fault. Darn, get on that.
Is there a reason why she thinks she can't get to this one? Or?
No, she's trying to figure out a way to bring the other one, red one, in. I would not be thinking that at all.
I would be trying to get two. You can hit this and roll over in front of the other one. You can't get the inside roll. That's impossible.
Okay.
Good. You hit this here, moving it.
Yeah, normal.
Try to roll across here.
Yeah.
There's a number of things can happen here too, Linda. If it happens to curl too much and you catch the corner of your own red one sitting in the 12 foot, it'll come off the side of that that yellow stone and it'll squirt forward.
I can't even play that.
Oh no, you wouldn't want to. You just want to draw in there.
Yeah.
Also keeping our eye on the game between Scotland and Norway as they play in 10. Norway with the hammer, but Scotland with a chance to run the Norwegians out of stones. Hit and roll over and roll behind for Switzerland. Now it's Kirsty Hay. Up 6-4 against Gordy Nordby. Jammed it at the back.
But it looks like Scotland's lying three.
Triple there. Triple without jamming.
To tie. Jordy Nordby's going to have a look. Anna Woods is third. Try and line things up.
I don't know why Cristina played that with so much weight.
No, I don't either.
She really threw that hard, and she didn't have to. She knew the path down there.
Cathy taking basically the edge of the 8 foot, 12 foot to try and draw into the 4 foot.
Lots of room.
Whoa, ladies, look, you can't.
Lots of room.
No, we need it.
Kate Horn Watch says room. They need
whoa,
it. Rushers said they need it.
Just right here. Whoa. Sit. Great shot.
Well, nice brush. Good judgment by that front end.
And you give Kate and Brenda a lot of credit. They were yelling whoa all the way, and they never got off it for a moment.
So a chance. Can she make a triple here, Jordy Nordby? Now she'll find the hole instead and kill her own. And that's three for Scotland, and they'll win it the final 9-4. So Kirsty Hay bounces back after giving one away in the morning draw to Finland. And she now goes to 2-3. Norway with the loss, Jordy Nordby drops to 3-2. Switzerland, Cristina Lestander. Trying to get a deuce here if she can. For two. And so they'll take the game to the 10th. Switzerland trails by one. Canada. And Borst will have the hammer coming home.
JVC's GR-DVX, the next generation digital video camera that has it all. Built-in flash, amazing digital effects, super clear LCD viewfinder, and multimedia interface with video capture and PC editing. The GR-DVX, only from JVC.
Something to contribute. Some are blessed with speed. Some have guts. There are those with agility and others with power. But there is one thing we all share, a dream. And although it weighs only 30 pounds, it'll take the strength of an entire team to hoist it.
If you care, Simonize it. Get professional results at home with Simonize Gel Car Wash. Clean and enhance the shine of paint, leaving the protection of Teflon. Clean and protect your entire vehicle with Simonize Gel Protectant, bursting with nutrient-enriched beads. Each application revitalizes, nourishes, and adds the lasting protection of Teflon. The Simonize family of car care products are available at Canadian Tire.
Today to join the MS Super Cities Walk in your community.
Just one game remains here in this women's fifth draw of these four worlds. And with Denmark's win, they are the only team that remains undefeated at five straight wins. Germany now 4-1. Sweden's win 4-1, Canada with a win can join them. Norway with the loss drops to 3-2. Scotland picks up the win. Switzerland will either be 2-3 or 1-4, and Japan remains winless. So the first stone was put there by Switzerland, and then it was Kate Horn who plays the tick. And then the second lead stone for Switzerland. So that's your first three, and now we're live, and you haven't missed a thing with Canada's most comprehensive curling coverage.
Hurry.
Two lovely shots by Kate, but Ray, we were saying, why wasn't Switzerland sweeping that first attempt?
If you believe Russian does anything, you should have been over there sweeping that. And if you take the red one, even what, 1 foot, you can brush it 1 foot. It touches the boards. It comes back to the center. Right? Cristina just watched it. I don't understand that.
And the interesting thing, the World Curling Federation rules, between the tee lines, the entire team can sweep their stone, and that's if you're the delivering team or the non-delivering team. In Canada, if your rock is set in motion in a tick, only the acting skip, the person in charge of the house, can do that sweeping. So they could have had all four if they wanted to try and get that red one to touch the bumper and come back. But even Cristina didn't make the attempt. Two nice shots by Kate, though.
Yeah, I just don't understand that.
He's suggesting that everybody should just come down and
they can if they want and wait and watch the tick and be the ready
to just hustle back and get ready to go.
Now they are tight on time, actually, Switzerland. I don't think that was a factor, though.
But that's interesting. You come down and come on, everybody, let's jump on it.
Well, I mean, even if you don't get it to the board, you should try to.
No,
that's the whole point.
The lane of the Rulu. As we play here in 10, Canada leading 6-5, and they do have the hammer.
Right off, peel.
Brenda Bomer.
Hurry!
Hard. Go, Heather, go.
And it'll roll and hang on to the edge. It all begins with baseball tonight. Labatt Blue Jays baseball, Tuesday and Wednesday. Tomorrow and Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time, the Jays and Minnesota Twins.
Quite a week. Golf, curling, baseball, hockey coming up. Boy, I'll tell you, we got it all.
Was that your golf game you were referring
to,
right?
No, I'm talking about the Masters coming up, NBA basketball, hockey coming up next week, curling this week, we got it all. Doesn't get any better than that.
You are going to watch the Masters and just pick up a few pointers for your golf game, I'm sure, though.
Yes, sir. There's lots of money to be made here. Chuck Hay is here. I'll certainly get some of that. Kei Sugihara is here. Terry Bronson's coming. Don Duguid's coming. I am looking forward to quite a bit of extra cash in the coming week.
Well, Switzerland certainly has rocks in play. They're not the center line guards they were hoping for, but they are stones that could be used. I'll keep trying to put up that perfect guard and hope for a miss.
So you forgot.
Reminder, we'll be back with you on Tuesday. 1 p.m. Eastern Time, that's 10 a.m. Pacific, the fifth draw of men's play. And it's Canada, Wayne Madaw, the only undefeated team now at 4-0. It was against Paul Pustovar from Hibbing, Minnesota at 1-3.
I do hate to tell people, though, that Graham McCarroll's numbers did fall below 90%. So hard to believe. Hate to tell everybody, Graham, but he's still playing so well.
Notice I didn't mention playing against Wayne Madaw or Graham McCarroll or Ian Tedley.
On the golf course.
Any of those guys that can play. The guys I mentioned, of course, can't play.
I saw you play once last year, too.
Yeah, I was awful at
it. Yeah, you couldn't play either.
I only played at the level of the player I'm playing with.
That's
course,
true. Yeah, thanks.
Okay. One more center guard for Cristina.
You really do just play for the nose hit, don't you?
You're hoping for anything at this stage. You know that if you draw behind one of the other guards, Cathy Borst is going to have the entire 8 foot to draw to.
Okay,
peel. Four
careful,
foot would be wide
hurt,
open.
Okay. Don't hit it too thin.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Gets pretty quiet in a building with some 3,000 people.
No!
Whoa! Clean, clean,
whoa!
Clean! Shot. Brenda, Brenda, you gotta follow
the team
back.
I'm afraid I was gonna run there.
There's a good comment for you all to listen to. Cathy came down, went right to Brendan
Shut
Tate, and said, look, I want you to follow this all the way down and take the times, the split times all the way down so you know where it's digging in and where it's sliding. It's something that you talk about often.
I do. I think it's really important at this stage of the game. Everyone else is off as far as the curling games go. We know the frost has been developing. We know there are spots that are very different across the sheet. And for the players, if this next one by Switzerland gets hidden, Cathy will have to play a draw.
Well, the Scott Tournament of Hearts, we saw Audrey Frey walk miles doing that. The lead for Anne Merklinger. She followed every stone down. Final stone.
It's part of Audrey's workout. That's why she's always in such great shape.
Yes.
Up and down the ice.
Switzerland's Cristina Lestander trailing by one.
Be a touch too much ice for this shot.
Should probably take it back if that's the case. No, it's just going to grind in.
And stop. Top eight.
Let me see.
Doesn't even have to hold the shooter now. Canada up by one.
A few.
Okay, that's normal here.
Cathy Borst and Canada, a takeout away from winning their fourth and going to 4-1. And they do. Canada will pick up two.
That was a good game. You made a nice shot in the set.
Yes.
And win it 8-5.
Thanks. That was a good game. Nice game.
Canada is now 4-1. Switzerland 1-4 through five rounds of women's play.
This year, we pay tribute to Bibb, the Michelin Man. For over 100 years, he has symbolized the Michelin spirit in racing, heavy industry, agriculture, and even in cycling, reflecting our never-ending quest to invent the best and safest tires in the world. Michelin, celebrating 100 years of innovation, because so much is riding on your tires.
Another case of boredom twitch syndrome?
Nothing relieves boredom twitch syndrome like Star Choice Digital Satellite Television. Over 90 channels of movies, sports, and entertainment. All with cinema quality picture and CD quality sound.
Honey, our favorite movie! Oh, thank you.
For a retailer in your community, call now. Finally, the choice is yours. Star Choice.
If you care, Simonize it. Get professional results at home with Simonize High Gloss Car Wax. The protection of Teflon in one easy step. Durable paint protection and a lasting shine. Clean and protect your entire vehicle with Simonize Gel Protectant, bursting with nutrient-enriched beads. Each application revitalizes, nourishes, and adds the lasting protection of Teflon. The Simonize family of car care products are available at Canadian Tire.
Time now for the TSN turning point in Canada's win over Switzerland.
Well, after an absolutely marvelous shot in the seventh end, a raise to get it to steal a single, Cristina, Lestander has a chance here to get around a guard and freeze to the face of a stone and make it very difficult on Canada to score one, at least, or if nothing else, hold her to one. But she slips too far. You can see it just doesn't curl, and it's a little too heavy. Slips back, and it gives Cathy Borst a draw for three, and that really turned the game right over.
Three in the eighth, broke it open, 8-5, the final. A cash donation will be made to the Coaching Association of Canada for training and development of coaches in amateur sport. On behalf of TSN, Cathy Borst is one game behind the leader, Denmark.
Since 1982, Scott Paper has been the proud sponsor of the Scott Tournament of Hearts.
That's right, Gavin. Scott Towels has been there for the spills of victory.
And Scotties was there for the disappointments of defeat. Oh, that was a tough loss.
Here's Sandra Schmerler and the Scott product team practicing their winning form.
What great action! That Scott team really delivers!
That was great. As always, the Scott Tournament of Hearts is brought to you by this family of fine Scott Paper products.
It was about the time that gold was discovered on Bonanza Creek that the Canadian Bank of Commerce set out on the epic trek to the Klondike to open the first official bank. There was plenty of gold, all right, but the men knew they could trust the bank because they were there on behalf of the government and could see a larger dream, a dream called Canada.
As in the past, CIBC continues to play a pioneering role by investing in Canada's vision of the future. Canadian Imperial Bank of Commerce, seeing beyond.
Wouldn't putting your stars together with our five-star rating be a bright thing to do?
Remember, kids in the back seat.
A lot can happen. Woo-hoo! Out of the blue. The back blue. Woo-hoo!
If you care, Simonize it. Get professional results at home with Simonize Gel Car Wash. Clean and enhance the shine of paint, leaving the protection of Teflon. clean and protect your entire vehicle with Simonized Gel Protectant, bursting with nutrient-enriched beads. Each application revitalizes, nourishes, and adds the lasting protection of Teflon. The Simonized family of car care products are available at Canadian Tire. The 1998 Ford World Curling Championships on TSN are brought to you by Ford Motor Company of Canada Limited. By Karcher, quality cleaning equipment. By Labatt, good things brewing. And by Simonize Car Care Products. If you care, Simonize it. Simonize is available exclusively at Canadian Tire.
Just a reminder, we're back with you Tuesday at 1 p.m. Eastern Time. That's 10 Pacific. The fifth draw of men's play. Canada, Wayne Madaw looks to make it five straight as he plays the U.S. Paul Pustovar. And as you can see, Canada, the only undefeated men's team. Stay with us. We'll join NHL Be a Player. It's coming up next on TSN, followed by Sports Desk at 2 a.m. Eastern, 11 Pacific. So Cathy Borst wins over Switzerland, one game back of Denmark that lead it all at 5-0. Till Tuesday, Canada's most comprehensive curling coverage is here on TSN.